lot of these niggas be in chairs. They can't stand us. Sheesh. Hearing us march is like an anthem. Yeah, we hear the sick, the lame, we tell them stand up. But some of these niggas is bitter, they bring cancer. Some of these preach for hire, we bring answers. Like karate, we keep growing higher and higher. Stole my treasure to heaven, that's a wire, wire. Transfer. We in dangerous places, but we still say, waiting at home is a high play. Oh, you think you hard with your AK? I got 144K. Fighting over blocks, we don't take you serious. We teach from the Bronx up to Nigeria. Filling up my cup till it runs over. Going hard till I go home.
Okay, we pull up in the hood where they say it ain't safe. It's all good.
Since you're mad, so I like trying to figure out where to fit in. Bishop pulled up on me and told me, Lord, I'm beginning. This was on the side, but we post up some like fishing. This was well accepted, no longer know what we're getting. Super Saiyan and demons and doctors, I'm like with Goku. 1611 King James Virgin, that's where we go to. Just keep on your seatbelt and know that there ain't no eating. But if you see them cherries and berries, don't get too scary. Mrs. Officer, Mrs. Officer, please take the handcuffs off of us. We ain't hear nobody, so get off of us. Kin, but excuse my friend, I represent the jungle, I'ma say that then. I remember all the spirit, now from way back when. And I know you pulled me over, cause from way back then.
We probably about to pull up in the hood where they say it ain't safe. It ain't safe.
Men of Israel, let's rise and face Jerusalem. Men of Israel, blow trumpet. Trumpet down.
Holy Father, God of heaven, we giving you praise in this holy Sabbath, Lord. Thank you for waking us out of the darkness, Lord, and giving us the marvelous light. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, we also pray for our brothers and our sisters that are sick. Heal them quickly and speedily, brother. We also pray for our brothers and our sisters, Father, that may stand this truth, that may endure to the end. We also pray for our son and our daughters as well, that may endure to the end. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, Father, we also thank you for these holy prophets you have sent into us today, Lord. We may humble ourselves and heard them, then we may keep your commandments in the faith of your Son, Jesus Christ. We also thank you, Lord, for our sisters that helping us to build. We also thank you, Lord, for these brothers that go throughout the four corner and preach your gospel, Lord. Send your angels to protect them. Do not let the enemy do them any harm. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, continue sending your angels to dwell among us, Father. Continue sending these great men, fathers, so they may help us build strong foundations. They may help us to go throughout the earth, build strong foundations to our brothers and our sisters that scattered throughout the four corners of the earth. Father, giving us the grace, giving us the compassion, and giving us the mercy, Lord, we will build. In the name of your Son, Jesus the Christ, our Father, which is in heaven, honor be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. As it is in heaven, let it be on earth. Give us each day our daily bread, and forgive us for our sin. Forgive us our sins against us. Lead us not into temptation. Deliver us from all evil. The kingdom is yours in the power and the glory. Father, we pray that, Lord, you may destroy all our enemy, the heathen, they may never rise up again. Father, we also pray for our brethren that in error, Lord, that may repent and keep your commandments. Let the whole congregation say hallelujah.
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 Father, we also thank you, Lord, for the bread, also for the drink. In Christ we pray, we ask, amen.
Men of Israel, sons of God, patient saints, sons of God, head salute,
bow sacrifice,
salute down, face sisters, To the honorable daughters of Sarah, we say shalom.
Most High Christ bless.
Hey, shalom, 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 Israel. Shalom. Guess where we at?
We in this building.
We in the building, Israel. We in here. We in here. We don't know where you at, but we in here. Praise to the Most High, man. Give us the opportunity to bless Connecticut. We have Captain Hadaniah. What's going on, brother?
Hey, shalom, shalom. Good to see y'all, family. I ain't see y'all in a while. All praises.
Give me, this is not in my notes. Give me Hebrew 13. I think it's 17. It's what pop up in my head. We in the building. Come on, you ready?
Yes, sir. This is the book of Hebrews, chapter 13 and verse 17. Obey them that have the rule over you, and submit yourselves, for they watch for your souls.
Stop. Yeah, man, who can help us here? Okay, we read this scripture all the time. That's a reason it popped up in my head. Who can help us here, brothers?
Give it to him.
Anyone. Hey, give it a try. For God's sake. Do something for God's sake. Come on. Come on.
It means to obey the leadership that are over you.
Why is that?
Because they're the ones that's watching for your souls.
Okay. Anything else? You notice in that verse? Come on. Yeah, give me that.
Shalom, sir.
No matter what. Wisdom of Solomon 9. You're going to know what I want. Come on.
What you think might be grievous for you, they're like fathers looking over you to take care of you.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. Everything sounds good. Give me the wisdom of Solomon. This is me why.
Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 9 and verse 14. Mm-hmm. For the thoughts of mortal men are miserable.
That's why we need leaders. Read it again, brother.
For the thoughts of mortal men are miserable.
Y'all see that, brothers and sisters? That's why we need these men. We need your Bishop Netanyahu. We need your deacons. We need your captains. We need your officers. Read it again, brother.
For the thoughts of mortal men are miserable.
Remember what that class is about. Mortal to immortal, right?
Yes, sir.
Now we learn about mortal man. What is the mortal man had in common? All mortal men had in common?
The thoughts of mortal men are miserable, and our devices are but uncertain.
You see that? We hardly can decide. We hardly can think right. We hardly can think right. So God said, you know what? I know what I made. Now let's read Hebrew again. We're going to go right back there. We're going to come right back there.
The book of Hebrews, chapter 13 and verse 17.
Come on, man.
Obey them that have the rule over you.
That's why we have to obey these leaders that God sent over us. Because there was a dent to this thing. What y'all think? These guys were also dent to these things, man. Y'all here playing game. Come on, now let's go back.
Wisdom of Solomon.
Yep.
This is the book of Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 9 and verse 14. Mm-hmm. For the thoughts of mortal men are miserable.
The thoughts of mortal men are miserable. Our thought is miserable, brothers. Come on.
And our devices are but uncertain.
You see that? Our device, we hardly can make the right decision. Come on.
For the corruptible body presseth down the soul.
I want your guys to understand that. That's why these men were sent into you. Read that part again.
For the corruptible body.
You are in a corruptible body. All of us understand that. You are in a mortal body.
Sir.
Come on, read that part again. Read that piece again.
For the corruptible body.
Uh-huh.
Presseth down the soul.
Pressing down the soul. You see? That. You know what that scripture really saying? You against yourself there. That's you against yourself. So you need these leaders to guide you the right way because you hardly can think the right way to go about things. But these great leaders going to bring you back home. Come on.
And the earthly tabernacle weigheth down the mind that museth upon many things.
You see that? All of us have a mind, right? So why would God send these holy apostles back? Because they understand, God understand what he made. Read that little piece again.
And the earthly tabernacle weigheth down the mind that museth upon many things.
Yeah, you know what's so heavy behind that thing right here? Because a lot of us who saying that, you know, because I had talked to many people. People saying that, you know what? I'm going to follow Christ. But the statement is, I'm going to follow Christ. Have you ever seen Christ? But Christ said, who over you? Leadership, right? So as soon correction come, you heard brother said or sister said, I'm going to follow Christ. You're going to follow Christ. Have you ever seen Christ? But they're showing you the mindset. People don't like correction. Come on, read that little piece again.
And the earthly tabernacle.
Yeah, man, show these pictures up, man. Don't just leave him there. Come on, man. Y'all supposed to be in the spirit. Flow with us. Mm. Flow with us. Wow. Don't just leave him there. Why pull it if you're going to just leave him there? Mm. Hell, guys, stay in the spirit back there.
Yes, sir.
Come on.
And the earthly tabernacle weigheth down the mind.
So that's why God will send these leaders. You see these leaders? Put back the leaders. Put in these pictures up. You just leave him there. Do something for God's sake. Come on.
And the earthly tabernacle weigheth down the mind that museth upon many things.
That's why you see these great leaders wising up. Because they understand, God understand how we made, how he made us. He said, you're not going to get it, but I will send leaders that can help you. I will send leaders that can lead you. I will send leaders that can lead you. But a lot of us, we don't want their leaders that can lead us. You understand? We want to cut up in whatever we want to cut up with. But you're going to find out. Yeah, man, give me, I'm going to go through that white quick. Yeah, give me Matthew 10. We're going to jump through that white quick. And start at 37. Yeah, I got a lot there I want to jump to.
This is the book of Matthew, chapter 10 and verse 37. He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me.
Stop. Read it again.
He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me.
Where your mind is sticking you when you read that verse right here? If you're in the spirit this morning. Where your mind take you? I'm going to read it again. Because you're supposed to be in the spirit.
Stand up.
Read it again.
He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me.
Help me here, brother.
You have to love nothing more than Christ, neither your life more than Christ. Mm.
See where your mind is taking you. Give me Jeremiah. Trim your ways. That's where your mind is supposed to take you. It's supposed to take you to precept. Mm. You understand? Your mind is supposed to take you to precept. When you see these teachers are teaching, guess what? Your mind is supposed to take you to precept. Not confused. Your mind's supposed to take you to precept. This Come the, on, brother. This Help me book, out there.
This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 2 and verse 33.
Uh-huh.
Why trimmest thou thy way to seek love?
The Lord is asking a question. Why you trim your way to seek love? Why are you trimming your way to seek love? Then we just read in Matthew 10, 37. So you're going to trim your way to be loved by who? Your parents, your family. That's what Matthew 10, 37 want us to understand. Finish that verse in Jeremiah, the whole thing.
Why trimmest thou thy way to seek love?
Come on, man.
Therefore hast thou also taught the wicked ones thy ways.
Because guess what? When you leave the truth, guess where you turn to be? Guess where you at? Of a grandma, of a mom, mm-hmm. of a daddy, of an uncle. Cousin house, back to the barbecue, back to the turkey days, back to Christmas, back to Thanksgiving, because we see it all over again. Because you trim your way to be loved. You understand? All this time you are sitting here, you didn't build yourself to nothing. So now when the flood came, trouble came, tribulation came, guess where you turn to? Back to mom house, back to the dirty couch. That's why we keep telling you, do something for God's sake while you're in here. Don't sit up in here like you don't have nothing inside your brain, man. You have to build to something. Why are you sitting in here anyway if you ain't building nothing? All these class, all these captain, deacons, officers, bishop lined up for you because they know how you think. Your mind be wandering around here like you crazy. That's why when correction come, It's hard for you to take it. Because why? Because you've been feeding yourself with the world. That's why it's hard, because correction come with the Bible. So why, when correction come, you feel grievous? You feel angry? You feel mad? Yeah, man, shout out to Captain Zakai. Zakar, man. That was a great class, brother. That was a great class. Oh, yeah, that was good stuff. Yeah, come on, brother.
Back to Matthew.
Yeah, come on.
Matthew chapter 10, verse 37. He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me.
You heard what Christ said. If you tram your way to be loved by these people, you're not worthy. You're not worthy. You're not worthy, brother. All these time you've been sitting here, then the day come, you find out you're not worthy. Come on, man. We have to. Yeah, I remember many people. Like, for example, I had a council. Let me see. Many people we have council with. It's one thing we tell these people. You understand? Yeah, there was a sister, I mean, that who left. Then I said, sis, you don't leave us no room to fight for you. And she said, what you mean? I said, why you just pack all your stuff and bounce? You should have just dwell with a sister. Pick a little clothes and just go over there. Why you choose to go outside? What God? I mean, you have meet new families. You know what I mean? You have elder sisters. You have sisters. You have brothers. What's so wrong with you? Now you pack everything, go back in the world. Then you think your mom will give you counsel? You think your dad will give you counsel? Are you kidding me? Wow. That's interesting. All these times you've been sitting here, you never understand the scriptures. Wow. Come on, man.
Matthew chapter 10, verse 37. He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me.
Is not worthy of me. Because you better be worthy, brother. That's why, because you see me what? I want your guys to focus on something, right? Give me Matthew 19. We're going to read, start at 27. He that love mother, father is not worthy. Wow. That's some banging words right there. Come on, man.
This is the book of Matthew, chapter 19, verse 27.
Then, brother, how could you made, you was made mortal. How could you made immortal if you don't understand what God trying to do? All these time you come in this earth with the mother and the father, we all know that. So why you think Christ saying what he's saying, brothers? You're not worthy of them, because you're going to lift these people above the God that creates you, the God that creates the soul, the God that creates the flesh, the God that will lead you. You prefer your carnal family more than the spiritual family. That's a simple spirit. Come on.
This is the book of Matthew, chapter 19, verse 27. Then answered Peter and said unto him, Behold, we have forsaken all and followed thee. What shall we have therefore?
I want y'all guys to understand. Listen to what Peter said. I want each one of you to have that mindset. What I mean by that, brother? What I mean by that? Read it again. Let me ask these brothers a question. I need them to know. I need to know they're in the same mind frame as us, man. They ain't coming here wasting time. Because we're in a battle, man. This is a spiritual battle, brothers. When Satan knock you out of the horse, guess what you do? You shake it off and get right back up.
Do not
let him knock you out that long, bro. Shake it off and jump back in the horse. Come on.
Then answered Peter and said unto him, Behold, we have forsaken all and followed thee. What shall we have therefore?
Stop. Who can help me with that verse? Let me see if you're thinking. Don't go too deep, brother. I already give you the answer. All you have to do is just think.
They gave everything up to follow Christ, Peter said. What more now?
Say it again.
They gave up everything to follow Christ, Peter said. He's saying.
So what do you mean by everything? What do you think he mean by that?
Friends, family, money, businesses, everything.
What we just read earlier. You understand? Come on.
Then answered Peter and said unto him, Behold, we have forsaken all and followed thee.
We have to have the mindset with us. Then I want your guys to go deeper within that verse. We have to have a mindset like we already lose it all. not going to lose it. We already lose it all. That's the mindset you must have. Not going to lose it. You already lose it all. That's that mind you're going to have to build yourself into. So when things happen, so you'll be able to stand strong. Because you already know things going to happen. You understand? You know what God is always doing that we don't pay attention to? You know that, let me see. Damn, that's a scripture. Wow, wow, wow. I sent to Captain Malatias. Go to that thing. I said, God see everlasting to everlasting. Give me that. Yeah, come on. Read that thing again.
Matthew chapter 19, verse 27.
Mm-hmm.
Then answered Peter and said unto him, behold, we have forsaken all and followed thee. What shall we have therefore?
But this is what I want you to understand. When Peter make that statement, Peter already forsake already. He just didn't know that yet. Because when you read, when you start reading about Peter, guess what? He fled. You understand? He had to run. You understand? Come on. Uh-huh. Go ahead. Let's see what Peter. Hold on to that. Let's see what Peter had to do. Mm-hmm.
It's the book of Acts, chapter 12 and verse 8.
Uh-huh.
And the angel said unto him, gird thyself.
Gird thyself, Peter.
And bind on thy sandals.
Bind on your sandals. Come on.
And so he did.
So he did. Come on.
And he saith unto him, cast thy garment about thee and follow me.
And follow me. Come on.
And he went out and followed him. Hmm. And wist not that it was true, which was done by the angel.
Mm-hmm.
But thought he saw a vision.
Mm-hmm. But he thought he saw a vision. But that thing is happening right now. You understand? That thing is happening right now. But he saw it in a vision. Why that thing is happening to him. That's the power of God, man. Come on.
When they were past the first and the second ward, they came unto the iron gate that leadeth unto the city,
uh-huh,
which opened to them of this own accord.
Uh-huh.
And they went out and passed on through one street.
Mm-hmm.
And forthwith the angel departed from him.
Let me ask y'all guys something. If that put you in jail, right, then that angel come take you out. What you become? Let me see if you're thinking. Yeah, I guess you become a Jew. Or maybe Gentile. What you become?
You become a fugitive.
Yeah, say it loud, brother, with confidence. Come on, man.
You become a fugitive.
You become a what?
A fugitive.
Okay. Let's look at the word fugitive, brother, because you would think that your brothers and sisters understood that. That's why I want you to understand. Peter already lose it all. You understand? I want you to understand. You already lose it all, sister. You already lose it all, brother. You just don't believe it yet. But that don't mean it's not going to happen. Come on. Read.
Definition of fugitive. A person who has escaped from a place or is in hiding, especially to avoid arrest or persecution.
Yeah, what is the key word we want to net?
Escaped. Oh, to avoid arrest or persecution.
Read the whole thing. Read the whole thing. That's a word I want y'all to focus on there. It's more than one, but it's one I'm seeing if you're thinking. Come on.
A person who has escaped from a place or is in hiding.
Is in what?
In hiding.
Is in what?
In hiding.
Uh-huh. Because of what?
Especially to avoid arrest or persecution.
You see that thing? But us, we don't care about stuff like that. You understand? We don't care about persecution. We're going to go in these streets, right, teach these words.
Right.
You understand?
That's
we
right.
Learn from the best.
That's right.
I mean, we're going to apply the things we've been learning from the best. In our UIC, we learn from the best. You understand? So which of the leaders of our UIC you don't see standing in the front? Yes. Come on, brother. Show me some pictures, man. You was cooking the fire a little minute ago. Then now you start thinking about porn. Then there you go. You lose everything.
Verse 11.
Peter. Yeah, come on.
And when Peter was come to himself, he said, now I know of a surety that the Lord hath sent his angel and hath delivered me out of the hand of Herod.
You see that? The Lord has delivered him out of the hands of his enemy, Herod, the white man, the Caucasian man.
That's right.
You understand? We can see it clearly now. The white man is always against us, the children of Israel. You understand? The white man is the evil. We are the good ones. We are the good children. We are the children of the light. The white man is the children of darkness. They always go against us. You understand? All right. Where we at? Where we at? Let's go back. Let's go back, my brother.
Matthew chapter 19.
The everlasting life. Let's go to Sirach. Yeah, that's it. I want you to understand the God you're dealing with. But a lot of us, you know what we think? It's over for us. It's never over, man. As long you're in this flesh, as long you have breath, you can always repent, keep God's commandment, and live. Come on.
This is the book of Sirach, Ecclesiasticus, chapter 39, verse 20.
Start at 19.
Mm-hmm. Verse 19. The works of all flesh are before him.
I want you guys to always understand it about God. The work of all flesh is in the presence of the Lord. Why he's saying this? Because he sees things before it happens. So your work's already before him. He already know when Peter say, I forsake it all. The Lord say, all right, Peter, you just say that now until this thing about to take place in your life. Let's see how you take it, Peter. Come on.
The works of all flesh are before him.
The work of all flesh are before the Lord. Come on.
And nothing can be hid from his eyes.
You see that? Nothing you do can be hidden from the Lord. Nothing you do in this earth can be hidden from the Lord. He sees things before that happening. Come on.
He seeth from everlasting to everlasting.
You see that? His eyes is not like your eyes sees things, man. He sees things from what with the born again?
From everlasting to everlasting.
You understand that? He sees things that the eyes of God, when he look at things, things doesn't end. let me make sure you understand. The eyes of God, when he look thing doesn't end. Things continue. He can see the past. He can see the present. He can see the future. That's a mighty eyes to have. That's what he said. He sees things from everlasting to everlasting. I want your guys to understand that. That's it on that?
He seeth from everlasting to everlasting. And there is nothing wonderful before him.
You see, when he said there's nothing wonderful before him, meaning he made it. It's not he's surprised by it. Oh, damn, I saw Haiti in affliction, God surprised. I saw Gaza in war, like God surprised. No, the white man placed the right place. The Arab been placed in the right place in the Gaza Strip. You understand? The Lord line all the Arab nation and put the little white boy right in the middle. They call themselves so-called Jews. You far from become a Jew, white man.
That's right.
That's right.
Then you see, when you look at the white man, that's the most disgusting things. They claim to be Jews. I mean, the scripture describe it, man. Unlawful nation. Then there's another word they use. A wicked nation. And now he trying to be the Jew. Come on, man. You far away. Look at you. That's who you are.
He needs some milk.
Dirt and filth. That's who you are. Hardy can take a shower. Come on.
Back to Matthew, sir.
Yep, back to Matthew. Now we understand the eyes of the Lord, brothers. You understand? Nothing surprised the Lord. So what you see in Haiti today, nothing surprised the Lord. These things been to making. Yeah, let's give me a few videos about. Yeah, did I send you a few videos about barbecue? I think I did. Yeah. The eyes of the Lord. Read that scripture again. You just read. The last end that I want.
Yes, sir. Sirach chapter 39, verse 20. Mm-hmm. He seeth from everlasting to everlasting.
Yes.
And there's nothing wonderful before him.
I'm going to show you. There's nothing wonderful before the Lord. Let's show what's going on in the news today about Haiti.
Hey, read that next one. Right,
verse 21, sir.
Mm-hmm.
A man need not to say, what is this? Wherefore is that? For he hath made all things for their uses.
You see that? He hath made all things for their uses. Includes what, brothers? When he say he hath made all things for their uses. Job says something very heavy. When the Lord take everything. What did he say? He hath made everything for our use. For us to use. Good and evil. Good and evil, but So when you see evil, you should not be surprised. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, wherever you see evil, oh no, my God, I cannot believe this. Oh Lord, mercy. Come on, man. I send you 3 videos about barbecue.
The nation of Haiti has been in trouble more or less for quite some time now, at least 100 years, depending on how you count. It's been the poorest nation in the hemisphere. But there have been periods of relative brightness in Haiti. Today is not one of them. That country is in what appears to be total collapse with no governing authority apart from
because
roving
band. Stop that. Because that been into making probably like a good 60 years ago. They've been working it to get it that way. To make it where we see it today. You understand why? Because of our own brothers sell our soul to the white man. Right. To the French, to the white man in Canada. You understand? French, America, France, and Canada. Our soul been sold to these men because of our unjust leaders, wicked leaders, black men, black women. All right, so nothing surprised under the sun. Give me the next one, brother. Did I send you all 3? Yeah, say something.
And that thing is systematic design. You understand? This systematic design to keep us down like the way they're doing. Because nowhere in the world they say Haiti is a poor country, but they got all this ammunition and all these damn updated guns. You understand? Right. AK-47s, AR-15. Where they get all these weapons from? Because these people systematically designing it for us to be going at each other like that, you understand? For us to tear our own neighborhoods up and our own communities up, you understand? Even though they there and they fighting, right? They there and they fighting, but where they getting these weapons from?
Mm-hmm.
These places like U.S. dropping these weapons to over there in Haiti before they could be self-destroyed, you understand?
Because all these things happened to Haiti because of us not keeping the commandment of God. All these things was prophesied. Yeah, you remember what he told Ezra? You don't see evil yet. Evil going to be multiplied on this earth. You imagine that the little island as Haiti, how many guns they're dropping that thing? You understand? Then the church, all the guns, everybody's selling guns. You understand? In Haiti. Why? Because they want to see the destructions of our people, man, the tune of Israel, which is the tribe of Levi. You understand? They want to see them because they were the first black independents in the Caribbean. You understand? Yeah, go ahead.
The most powerful man in Haiti is far from a politician. The gang leader known as Barbecue has been promising a civil war that
because we have we had a chance to talk to our brother Barbecue, man. You understand that he understand the thing he's into, what he gonna take. And I mean, when we sit down and talk to him, he understand he's blood in, blood out. You choose that way, it's blood in, blood out. You understand? He understood that. So he laid down his life for that. So a lot of people were saying that, you know what I mean, he's cannibalistic, he eat people, he do this and that. But at the end of the day, guess what? We have to blame the America, we have to blame the French, we have to blame Canada. That's who we have to blame that put Haiti in the condition it is for these black men to rise up against their oppressor. Against the wicked of the white man. But if you're not seeing clear, you understand, this is the place that we're going to make sure we take the smoke off where you can see clearly. Come
That's
on, brother.
Right.
The government.
It is a whole
you heard
system
what he said? It's a system. They understood that. The government that they are is a system that went to Haiti. Unless you know the system, you will never understand why Haiti is in the state of mind they're in. Come on.
To destroy. We're not going to lie here. We're not in a peaceful revolution. We're making a bloody revolution in the country.
They understood that. Then you got the Syrian in Haiti. You got the so-called Jews in Haiti. You understand? Selling guns to Haitian people. You understand? You have the Syrian that whole Haitian hostages as well. You understand? Man, but guess what? We have to stand up. Somebody has to stand up. You understand? If he don't stand up, who's going to stand up? You know, but he understood when he stand up, why he stand up for. You know, blood in is blood out. It's the same thing as us. We stand up for our people, for righteousness. It's blood in, blood out. We're going to make sure our people get this word. We're going to make sure they apply this commandment into their life. You understand? Come on. Yeah, give me the next video. Because people can see this thing here. They just play these men there. They're thinking that the whole thing began with him. No, the whole thing did not begin with him. That's 6 years into making, man. He's just a part of that problem. It is a peer. You understand?
And think about all the great resources that's there in Haiti. Mm-hmm. Haiti got much resources. That's mm-hmm. why they let them go in there and do that too. Well, they could go in there and steal all their resources, steal their money from our people, and keep our people oppressed at the same time.
Yeah, I was watching D.K. Malakaya. He had a video up about the gold. They say Haiti got more gold than every country in the world. Man, but look at Haiti. Do Haiti look like it got gold?
Yeah, and uranium.
Like Bishop Netanyahu would say, Haiti don't look like it got no gold.
They say, and
it look
uranium.
Like they got dust. We don't have no gold. That look like we full of dust there. Come on, man. Come on, Cap.
No, I said they saying that Haiti is full of uranium and gold. Mm-hmm. They got the precious things that they need, the cobalt things that they need to keep these things running, like Tesla. Yeah. They need that thing there.
Yeah, find me that video about the gold in Haiti. I wonder if you find it for me. Because I was looking for it, I could not find that thing. Yep. Now continue the next video. We have to understand this is a system. And our people caught up in it. Go ahead. That's a good one.
Now let's turn our attention to Haiti. The country's capital is under siege. Gangs have overrun Port-au-Prince. They're stepping up their attacks on the government. They're attacking police stations, burning them down to free inmates.
You know this. You know this. Go back. Start it all over again. I want you all to see the mindset of the media. Then don't be deceived, brothers. Start it from, okay, go ahead.
Now let's turn our attention to Haiti. The country's capital is under siege. Gangs have overrun Port-au-Prince.
Okay, stop.
They're stepping.
Right? If you read through that, you think the gangs start everything. Yep. You think the mindset they're sent out here is for you to believe the gangs start everything. That's that mindset the white men had. You understand? Why not said, but she cleared it out in that video. Come on.
Their attacks on the government. They're attacking police stations, burning them down to free inmates who then join the gangs on their rampage. But the focus is on two of these, the U.S. and France, because in a lot of ways, they're directly responsible for Haiti's present situation.
See, that she clear it out. What the condition of Haiti is the American that's still the goal. Would Haiti for 20 years, you understand? But then we have Citibank, Wabas are all our goals. You understand? You have to understand the mindset of the white man. They call him the evil door. And he is right. Just that. Come on, man.
France committed the original sin. They were the colonizers. The former slaves rose up and won their freedom from France.
When Toussaint, Toussaint and Dessalines, and there's a lot of Capalamord, and there's a few great leaders that was raised up in Haiti to trying to fight the oppressor. You understand? Man, but guess what? I guess that's barbecue time today then. Come on. He might not doing it in righteousness. We're not saying that. But at least he stand up for something. That's like we tell you guys, do something for God's sake. Don't come up in here. You ain't doing nothing. You're not in the kitchen. You're not doing nothing for this body. You just sit in here. Come on, man.
From France. France demanded 150 million francs, and Haiti spent the next 122 years repaying that money. For 19 years, the U.S.
Listen,
and its
Haiti had to pay the French with the money they take right now. They would have worth $21 billion. Yeah, now there would have been. Imagine you drop $30 billion in Haiti soil. We would have a little paradise in Haiti. But that's not, you have to understand, they don't want us to wise up. They want to make sure they keep us down because we were the first one to wise up and show show black people that can do it. They can fight against the oppressor. They ain't better than us. They're not so mighty because we have Dessalines wise up. We got Toussaint wise up. What's the weather name? Carpalamore, Henri Christophe stand up for the Haitian people. Come on.
As the U.S. and its banks ravaged this country, when the Americans were done, Haiti was left.
Yeah, I want you to bring it back a little bit, bro. I want y'all guys to pay attention.
150 million francs. And Haiti spent the next 122 years repaying that money. For 19 years, the U.S. and its banks ravaged this country. When the Americans were done, Haiti was left an impoverished mess. Mm-hmm. Now, those countries are gathering to decide Haiti's future. Hopefully, they won't make things worse.
Yeah, I want your guys to understand that she telling you who robbed Haiti. You understand? So a lot of time, they just thought you might see that barbecue look like he's a bad dude. Man, but that's all he can do. You understand? They're just like the people of Gaza, right? You understand? You put him behind wall. What you think they're going to do? They're going to fight back. But what the so-called white men say in Gaza, like that thing began when? When that thing he said that began in Gaza? November. Yeah, October 7, right? But that thing been going on for years with double S. Years. Triple S. With years unto making today. Then they want you to believe that just happened yesterday. October 7th. That just happened yesterday. But they're saying that that so-called Jew make this thing happen. They set up the whole thing to rob the Arab for their land. To rob them. Steal from them. Same thing they do to the native here in America. Those are the same people. What you think they're going to do? Same thing. Rob, steal. Come on. Yes, yes. Play that. The next one is there.
Kadem kap gabe sek pal ka ou. Me koman sitwayen sa anke la kaj. Ok? Me koman sitwayen anke la kaj. Sa son sitwayen kla.
Yeah, go ahead, brother. What's wrong with this guy?
Kaidi, ou malade pe a.
You're sick. Yeah, man, the last video I sent. That's the one you playing now? No, I want you to play the last video I sent. Because you just play barbecue one, right? And two. There's another one I sent. Where this one? Where you'll find this one? That was the one I sent? See? No, there was the three that I sent one where he have a white shirt in. Yeah. Where he trying to clean himself to be in the government. You know, that's what they all do. Oh, that's what you was playing earlier? Maybe I skipped. Maybe I didn't see that. Yeah, play it again. Yeah, he had a white shirt. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, no problem.
Hey, go back to the popular plots and they persuasions and commotions they go over there and bring to that country, you understand? Setting the disorder in that country, you understand? Out of chaos, they going to come in and play the heroes. But get that real quick, First Ezra 573.
Yes, sir, I got it.
Read that.
It's the book of First Ezra, chapter 5 and verse 73. And by their secret plots.
That's why they go in the news and saying this man is a cannibal, this man is evil. You understand? They got to put up this secret plot. You understand? They got to give them the guns to go and fight and battle and shoot up the area. You understand? For they could go in. They say, this man is evil. He wicked. For they could go in and take all the resources. They could tear that place down at the same time. So that's their secret plots. Go ahead.
And popular persuasions.
And with their popular persuasions. Go ahead.
And commotions.
And their commotions. They said, we got to send the army in. The gangs are taking over Haiti. You think they really going to let a gang take over Haiti? They ain't going to let that happen unless they want it to happen. Go ahead and play that.
Yeah, man, then I want you to, at one time, the Levi had their mind right. Mm-hmm. When we went off, get me that Deuteronomy 33. And we're going to start at verse 8. At one time, we have our mind right. When we stick to the Lord, when we stick to the law, when we stick to the commandments. But I want the Haitian people to understand there's going to be a payback for America. There's going to be a payback for the French. There's going to be a payback for the Syrian. There's going to be a payback for Canada.
Right.
They're going to be paid for what they do.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 33 and verse 8.
Mm-hmm. Which and wait after they play the video.
This is called barbecue. He's been giving speeches like this to huge crowds in Port-au-Prince.
He's trying to reform himself. So maybe he can have mercy from whatever they're going about to do to Haiti. Or he can be a part of that government somewhere. You understand? I want y'all guys to understand that one time my mind was right. That's it on that? Yeah, go ahead.
A lot going on here. It's hard to understand exactly what all of it means, but one thing Americans should keep in mind is there could be a massive, what we refer to as a refugee crisis, where a lot of the people you just saw in that video wind up in boats headed for Florida.
That's all they care about. That's all they care about. They don't care. They don't give a damn about our people, man. That's all they care about. Man, but I want you to read Deuteronomy 33. This is what the scriptures say about Levi. Pay attention.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 33, and verse 8. And of Levi he said, let thy Thummim and thy Urim be with thy Holy One, whom thou didst prove at Massah, and with whom thou didst strive at the waters of Meribah, who said unto his father and to his mother, I have not seen him, neither did he acknowledge his brethren, nor knew his own children. For they observed thy word, and kept thy covenant.
So read it again. Let me see if you're thinking now.
Who said unto his father and to his mother, I have not seen him, neither did he acknowledge his brethren, nor knew his own children, for they have observed thy word.
What do you mean by that? We just read that precept before. Let me see if you're thinking. We just read it before. Come on, brother. We need to know your guys staying in the spirit. You're floating with us.
It's like when Christ said, who loves thy mother or father before me? Mm. He's saying that they love the word before the mother.
Yeah, because
father.
What was happened to the Levi, you understand, they didn't care about whoever. If their mother, they would have stoned them. Right. If there was their children, they would have stoned them. If there was their uncle, they would have stoned them. If there was their auntie, they would have stoned them. Right. Because if they break their commandments. Is the same thing Christ is saying again. It's nothing new under the sun, brothers. We have to forsake these people. You understand? If they're not coming to learn this commandment, applying this commandment, all we can do is teach the word. But we can never trim our way to be loved by them, meaning they stop breaking God's laws. Yeah, I know people who saying that. Deacon Laba say, forsake your... No. If they tell you to break God's laws, flee from these people. That's what the scripture said. For the simple ones. Come on, brother.
Hey, get that in Acts 29 real quick. Mm-hmm. For they know that's not deacon words. Acts 5:29.
It's the book of Acts, chapter 5, and verse 29. Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, we ought to obey God rather than men.
Read that again.
Book of Acts, chapter 5, verse 29. Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, we ought to obey God rather than men.
So anything go against God, we're not doing it.
That's
right. They tell you eat pork, we're not doing it.
Right.
They tell you celebrate a birthday, don't do it.
Right.
Anything that go against God, you're not supposed to do. You're supposed to uphold the Lord's statute and commandments that God give you. You understand? It ain't going against God. Everything God tells us to do, that's what we got to do. Why? Because we got to stand before him when we leave this earth. You understand? We have many forefathers that died. Why? Because they ain't eat the pork. Many forefathers died. Why? Because they wasn't going to break the laws of God, period. You understand? And we got to have that same mindset. We'd rather obey God than hell what man say.
You see, read that verse again about the Levi.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 33, verse 9. Who said unto his father and to his mother, I have not seen him, neither did he acknowledge his brethren,
nor knew his own children, for they have observed thy word and kept thy covenant.
Because one thing, let's get Exodus 28. Let's read verse 9 right quick, just for the time's sake. But you see, Levi at one time have his mind right. You understand? But right now, Levi's mind ain't right. They're all mingled in their sins. That they wonder what's going on. They should not be amazed. That's the work of sin. You understand? Sin will bring you to a lower state. Come on.
The book of Exodus, chapter 28 and verse 9. And thou shalt take two onyx stones and grave on them the names of the children of Israel.
Mm-hmm.
Six of their names on one stone, and the other six names of the rest on the other stone, mm-hmm. according to their birth,
mm-hmm.
with the work of an engraver in stone. Like the engravings of a signet, shall thou engrave the two stones with the names of the children of Israel.
Come on.
Thou shalt make them to be set in the ouches of gold,
mm-hmm.
and thou shalt put the two stones upon the shoulders of the ephod, for stones of memorial unto the children of Israel. And Aaron shall bear their names before the Lord upon the two shoulders for a memorial. And thou shalt make ouches of gold and two chains of pure gold at the ends. Of wreathen work shalt thou make them, and fasten the wreathen chains to the ouches. And thou shalt make the breastplate of judgment with cunning work. After the work of the ephod, thou shalt make it of gold, of blue, and of purple, and of scarlet, and of fine twine linen.
Levi was glorified.
That's right.
Come on, brother.
For a score it shall be, being doubled. A span shall be the length thereof, and yes. a span shall be the breadth thereof. And thou shalt set in it settings of stones, even four rows of stones. The first row shall be a sardis, a topaz, and a carbuncle. This shall be the first row. And the second row shall be an emerald, a sapphire, and a diamond. And the third row, a ligure, and an agate, and an amethyst. And the fourth row, a beryl, and an onyx, and a jasper. They shall be set in gold in their enclosings. And the
I want you guys to understand that the glorious beautiful. Things that we once have. But look at the state we're in today. That's crazy, right? But I want the Levi to understand something. Let's get Revelation 2 and 26 right quick. All these things we're seeing, that's what our eyesight is seeing. But the Lord is behind everything. God Almighty is behind everything. He already see the solution. Same way he see the problem, he already see the solution.
That's right.
Come on.
This is the book of Revelations, chapter 2 and verse 26. And he that overcometh and keepeth my works unto the end, to him will I give power over the nations.
You see that? The Levi have to understand that. Yeah. Us keeping that commandment, when we overcome our trial, our tribulation, our sin, guess what? Power gonna be given to us to rule over these nations
right.
that oppress us. So Levi, you will have your chance one day.
That's right.
You know, Judah, you will have your chance one day.
That's right.
The 12 tribes, you will have your chance one day.
That's right.
Just right now, brothers, in your south, fight hard.
Right.
In your morning, fight hard. But one day, we will revenge.
That's right.
The Lord will give us the power to revenge what they did to us, man. You understand? It's just going to be like a dream, brothers. It's just going to be like a dream.
Next verse, Deacon.
Come on.
And he shall rule them with a rod of iron.
Y'all see that? That is hope in the other end.
That's right.
I don't know what y'all worry about. That is hope. Keeping that commandment, that is hope in the other end. Give me Micah 5:7. There is hope, brother, in the other end when you get your mind right. Keeping this commandment. Apply this commandment. Overcome you. Is you against you.
Micah 5:7.
Yes, sir.
This is the book of Micah, chapter 5 and verse 7. And the remnant of Jacob shall be in the midst of many people.
We're going to be in the midst of many people, all right? Come on.
As a dew
from the Lord.
Uh-huh.
And as the showers upon the grass
uh-huh.
that tarrieth not for man.
Yeah, we're not going to tarry for man. Come on.
Nor waiteth for the sons of men.
Come on.
And the remnant of Jacob shall be among the Gentiles.
Mm-hmm.
In the midst of many people, as a lion among the beasts.
No. I guess as a little chicken.
As a lion.
What about a little dog?
As a lion.
Yeah, what about a little pet?
As a lion.
What about cat?
As a lion.
You know what is the lion in the jungle? It's the king of the jungle. Yes. So we're going to be among these nations like a lion.
Yes.
They're going to be prey that day. Right, Cap? They're going to be the prey that day.
That's right.
At least show me a lion, brother. Show me something. Do something. You understand? Imagine that thing, man. We gonna hurt these people, man. Either they're gonna buy by these laws, or we gonna hurt these people. Understand that, brothers. That is hope in the other end. But before all these things, brother, we have to overcome ourselves. We have to overcome ourselves. We have to become mighty men like these men. Yes, you understand? That's what the worry is. Throughout the media, their worry, we standing up now. I'm going to show you guys. It's the same thing towards the Pharisee time. They had one thing. Every generation have one thing in common. I'm going to show it to you. Hold on to that. Give me Yeah, give me Acts. As a matter of fact, let's begin at Acts. Give me Acts. This is what the Pharisee thought, all right? You see, this is the mindset. Yeah, let's start. Okay, we started one. We're gonna
Acts chapter
jump.
One, sir.
Mm-hmm. Remember, all these things we just went out, brothers. Pay attention.
Acts chapter 1, verse 1.
Yeah, no, Acts 4. We're going to begin in verse 1. 1 to 4, right quick. Then we're going to do a little jump here, jump there.
This is the book of Acts. Chapter 4 and verse 1.
This is what the problem is, brothers.
And as they spake unto the people, the mm-hmm. priests and the captain of the temple and the Sadducees came upon them.
Okay, they come upon them. You remember the apostle is teaching the people, right? What do they need for salvation? What is their need? Their reservations. What their reservation is all about. Come on.
Being grieved that they taught the people.
You see that? Their leaders there, they're supposed to be the leader of the people. The Spirit let us know that they were being grieved. Mm. Believe it or not, these pastors, they're being grieved right now.
Right.
See our people waking up. I'm going to show you that mindset, though. Come on, brother.
Being grieved that they taught the people.
Because that's what, when they see us in these streets, they're being grieved. Because these people, they see, that y'all see, they do the march. Show me the march. You see these people that do the march? You see, these people that they're in this march, guess where they come from? The Christian church,
right.
Islam, that's Buddha, voodoo, Judaism. Yeah. You know what I mean? All type of religion. Then these leaders are angry. They are mad.
That's right.
Because guess what we're doing, brother? We wake up soul out of darkness. That's our job.
That's
right. If you didn't know your job, now you know your job. We wake up soul out of darkness. They've been bound by Satan. That's our job. Then when Satan see us in the spot, guess what? He come immediately. That's how dangerous you are, brother,
right,
when you're in the street. If Satan can send a spirit immediately, that means you're a powerful man.
Right.
But you don't know that yet. Come on, brother. Let's read. Let's put some sense into these people.
Being grieved that they taught the people
uh-huh.
and preached through Jesus the resurrection from the dead.
You see that? The resurrection from the dead. That's what they was teaching. Come on. We're gonna be alive again, brother.
That's right.
Come on.
And they laid hands on them and put them in hold until the next day.
Remember that said they were grieved. Yep. Now they're looking at them teaching. They put hands on them. Right? I want y'all guys to, what verse you in right now?
Verse 3, sir.
All right. When you in verse 4, let me know. Come on.
And they laid hands on them mm-hmm. and put them in hold mm-hmm. until the next day.
We're going to find out why there was grief, why they put their hands on them. We're going to find out. Come on.
For it was now eventide.
Now there was eventide. Come on.
Verse 4. Howbeit, many of them which heard the word.
Hold on, brother.
Yes, sir.
Read it again, brother.
Howbeit,
many of them which heard the word.
You see, many of them that heard the word while these apostles was teaching, right? That we're going to show you why that was grievous, why that was angry. Come on.
Believed.
You see why that was grievous? That saw our brothers, our sisters believe. What is it to be believed? Let's go to Sawak. You know what I want. What is it to be believed? Because Christianity say they believe. So we got to stop evil thoughts. What is it to believe? What is it? When they heard the word, they believe. So what did they do with their belief? Did they just sit in there behind? Come on, 32.
This is the book of Sirach, chapter 32 and verse 24. He that believeth in the Lord.
If you believe in the Lord, brothers and sisters, what you going to do?
Taketh heed to the commandment.
Then if you're not doing that, you're still serving Satan. Read it again.
He that believeth in the Lord taketh heed to the commandment.
See, when you believe in God, brothers and sisters, what do? You take heed to what? The commandment of God. Not in this time. You understand? None of our people want to keep the commandment of God. They still celebrate Christmas, Thanksgiving, Mother's Day, Father's Day. They still celebrate pagan holiday while they sit inside these dumb graveyard they call churches.
Right.
Our job is to unbound them because they're bound by Satan inside these churches. Come on, my brother. Right.
Back to Acts.
Yes, 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 sir.
Acts chapter 4, verse 4. Howbeit, many of them which heard the word believed.
Now, I want you to show me the picture before you show these men march and keep it in the thing for a minute. Come on.
And the number of the men was about 5,000.
You see me why they was angry? They saw 5,000 people repenting. They saw 5,000 people repenting, brothers.
Hey, Deke, what's everybody? Because the word believe, with believe, the word believe is the action word.
Right? That's right.
With the word believe come change. You understand? They changed. That's why 5,000 people stepped out. They heard the word and start changing their lives, bringing them back to the Heavenly Father.
Yes, that's good. That's good, Cap. Because our people in Christian church do that change. That inside Christian church, they're still doing the same thing they was doing in the world. Go in front of a Christian church. See what kind of people you see come out of there. Tie-dye jeans, tie-dye dress, just like they just left a whole house. I mean, you remember the whole house we was in the world? They're called club. Club was a whole house. You just go there to meet hoes. You used to call it clubs. Now you got the picture now. Club was a whole house. You go meet hoes. Not go to meet the right, like a woman to marry. This is what it is. You understand? You go there to meet hoes. You understand? Look at that. You see the churches? You see that? They're still dressed the same way to hit the churches. You understand? They have not changed. Look at that. Look at that. Look at this.
Hey, that was the old saying when a nigga come out of jail, right? They used to say, if you want to find a good woman, just go to the church. You'll get one out of there. They ain't say go get the word of God. They said go there and get you a woman.
Bro, I want you to read for again, my brother. That how the hell she gave us out of the church butt naked. Then she called upon the Lord. Our sister's bugged out, man.
This is the book of Acts, chapter 4, and verse 4.
Mm-hmm.
Howbeit, many of them which heard the word mm-hmm. believed.
Many of them that heard the word do believe. Come on.
And the number of the men was about 5,000.
5,000, brother. Let's show me, brother. Show me. We've been in these streets teaching. Show me.
That's right.
Show me. Show me. These men believe.
That's right.
They change the ways. You see that? These are men that believe. You see our people in the side? They could not believe it. They thought we were destroyed. They thought we would never make a comeback. The Lord said, hell no. My prophet is here. Don't worry. They're going to lead you the right way. And these are what you see in these streets. You understand? Brothers go hard in these streets to turn the world upside down. That's what
they
do.
That's right.
That's what we do, because the world have not been the same. The world, I'm saying it again, the world have not been the same since the Israelites stand up. Yes, you understand? Come on, my brother.
Acts 4, verse 4. Howbeit, many of them which heard the word believed, and the number of the men was about 5,000.
I'm going to show you, right? You see that say those that believe, you know what I mean? There were 5,000, right? I'm going to show you the mindset of these wicked Pharisees, right? What they thought. But I got to get that. I got to get that first. Go to Acts 2 and 41. There go the apostles again. They're at work again, brother. We supposed to be at work. Do something for God's sake. Read.
It's the book of Acts, chapter 2, verse 41. Then they that gladly received his word.
They that gladly received the words. Come on.
Were baptized.
They were what?
Baptized.
Come on, man.
And the same day, there were added unto them about 3,000 souls.
Y'all see that? 3,000. 5,000. That's how he's going to be, my brothers, in this last day. Pay attention, brothers. Don't go in this street teaching like a little coward. Don't go in this street teaching like a little chicken. Teach in the street like a lion, brothers. Teach in class like you are lions. Ready to devour your enemy. That's how our teacher is supposed to look, man. Show me the lion again, brother. Now you got brother that's teaching. He just like this. Nah, he got to look like this. Show me the lion with the fire, brother. Sometimes you're cooking. Show me the lion with the fire, brother. Come on, man. See, you're not thinking in there.
Hey, get Jeremiah 23:29 real quick to go along with Deacon saying, because you got to teach with fire, man. You got to leave it all right there, man. You can't try to think you're going to walk away. You understand? We out there, we're going to give our people the word if they hear it or forbear it. We're going to drop the word of God upon them. Go ahead, read that real quick.
Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 26. How long shall this be in the heart?
No, I said 23:29.
Excuse me, 29. Is not my word like as a fire?
That's how God word should be. It's supposed to be like a fire when you out there.
Yeah.
You're supposed to burn the people down with the word of God. You're supposed to force them, compel them to change their ways.
That's right.
Read.
Is not my word like as a fire?
Go ahead.
Saith the Lord, and like a hammer.
Like a hammer.
That breaketh the rock in pieces.
You got to break them to shreds, crumble them.
That's right.
Break down that evil that's inside
that's
them.
Right.
Rip it apart with the word of God.
You know, that's the same thing in Hebrew when he said he's just like a two-way sword. Is it saying the same thing?
You want
it's
that?
The same thing. When you're in the street, you ain't cutting nobody. You just. Brother, look crazy in these streets, man.
Then,
I had a thought there. Yeah, you see, show me the lion again. You see, when you're in the street, you're supposed to look like this. Now, brother. You have the horn over there? Can somebody blow the horn right quick for me? You see that? When we look like this, we have to sound like this.
Yes, sir.
Loud. We have to sound loud, brothers. So our people can hear that. They can see the fire. They can see the sword is coming. Two-way sword is coming at them. You understand? We're able to cut them. That brother's on. Something wrong with these brothers out here, man. Come on, brother.
Isaiah 58.
Yeah, okay.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 58, verse 1.
Mm-hmm.
Cry aloud.
Cry aloud, brothers.
Spare not.
We're not going to spare nobody, brothers.
Lift up thy voice like a trumpet.
Lift up your voice like a trumpet, brother. If you had a little voice, you better go in. Why are you taking a shower, brother? Where's your voice in the bathroom? Hey! Yeah. Do something. Do something. I don't care what you're going to do, but do something. But we got to change the teacher, please. Put another teacher up. Brothers, it's not lying enough. Brother, it's not fire enough. Come on.
Cry aloud, spare not. Lift up thy voice like a trumpet.
Brothers, when you come to take over a city, you understand, you have to sound like your voice have to sound loud.
Yes,
you have to look like a lion that ready to take the city, brother. Nobody going to respect you teaching like a little boy here, like a little girl there. Nobody going to respect you. See that? That's how you have to sound like, brother. What's wrong with y'all?
That's right.
Come on, brother. Let's go back. Let's go back to the 3,000 we pinned. Yes, we just read in Acts 4, 4,000 we pinned. We just read in Acts 2. What is that? 3,000 we pinned.
Yes, sir.
You see? That's why they're going to be angry at us. Mm. They're going to be mad at us because they don't want our brothers, our sister to turn from mortal to be immortal. That's what we're teaching out here. Mortal to be immortal. Let's get that in Wisdom of Solomon. I think he's one, right? Let's get that in Wisdom of Solomon. What is we teaching in the street? They're going to turn the mortal man to immortal. What do we teaching in the street? Yeah, you see that when they say watches will make a man immortal?
115. Yeah. Uh-huh. Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 1 and verse 15. Uh-huh. For righteousness is immortal.
Yeah, what did we teach on the street?
For righteousness is immortal.
Now let's get Deuteronomy 6:25. What is righteousness is immortal. So that's why we're trying to turn mortal man to immortal. Guess what? We're going to have hate, bro. We're trying to turn these men to be immortal. Come on, brother.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 6 and verse 25. And it shall be our righteousness if we observe to do all these commandments before the Lord our God, as he hath commanded us.
You see that? This is what we teach on the street. As he hath commanded us. We must teach our people laws, statutes, and commandments. Now let's go back to Wisdom of Solomon and we jump back again.
Yes, sir. Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 1 and verse 15.
Come on, man.
For righteousness is immortal.
You see that? What we teach in these street brothers, we teach in righteousness. Righteousness is immortal. The beginning of you turn to be immortal. You understand? So you better believe that. Now let's go back to Acts. So we don't lose that thought, brother. Read Acts 4 and 1 again. About the Greek, yes, all right? So we don't lose that thought. Why are these people going to be mad? Put these pictures up, bro. Put these pictures up. They're going to be mad when you see. They're going to be grievous when they see these prophets.
That's right.
Turn mortal man to immortal. That's our job. Come on.
This is the book of Acts, chapter 4 and verse 1. And as they spake unto the people, the priests and the captain of the temple and the Sadducees came upon them.
Because they don't understand. They don't understand, right? Read that little part again.
As they spake unto the people, the priests and the captain of the temple and the Sadducees came upon them.
Wall upon them. Come on.
Being grieved.
Being what?
Being grieved.
Being what?
Being grieved.
Oh, brothers. We're going to grieve these pastors. Because they're going to see our man being repentant. They're going to get so upset. You understand? They're going to start putting hands on us. They're going to go to the nobles. I'm going to show you guys something. How they think. Yeah, that's it. That's it. They're Israelite. They're no affected to it. They're no affected to these men. Now let's get that. How their mindset think. Let's get Acts 5, right? We're just going to read verse 24. This is the mindset of these dudes.
It's the book.
When they wise up upon you, I mean, this is their mindset. I want you guys to pay attention to that.
It's the book of Acts, chapter 5 and verse 24. Now when the high priest and the captain of the temple and the chief priests heard these things, they doubted of them whereunto this would grow.
What that mindset, Captain? They said, nah, this thing ain't going nowhere, man. They ain't going to go through nothing, man. But we just read 3,000 we pent. We just read 5,000 we pent. Oh, no, this thing ain't going to go through nothing. Nah, ain't going to go through nothing. But, brother, you fail the people. Your so-called pastors are a bunch of failure. Then guess what? They said, now this thing ain't going to grow. Would Israel turn back to their commandment, brothers? Would Israel turn back? Would Israel change? Yeah, they're going to change because Scripture said they're going to change. That's what the law is supposed to do. Let's get that in a proverb, brother. Let's get a proverb 19. Let's get that, what the law is supposed to do to people.
It's the book of Psalms, chapter 19, verse 7. Mm-hmm. The law of the Lord is perfect.
God's laws is perfect, brothers. Come on.
Converting the soul.
What God's laws are about to do?
Converting the soul.
Can I look at you towards the flesh? God said he's able to do what?
Converting the soul.
That's what we're looking for, brothers. When we're in the street, we convert in soul. We convert in soul. We convert in soul. That look at you like you're a regular guy. But we converted souls in these streets. Read that thing again, brother, with power.
The law of the Lord is perfect.
God's laws is perfect. Come on.
Converting the soul.
That's what we're doing right here, brothers. We converting soul. They're going to be angry. They're going to be grievous.
Hey, D, in my Bible, right, the Cambridge, they got number 16. If number 16 said restoring.
Restoring. Soul. Say, man, since you go there, Cap, man, you jump me to my verse. Yeah, let's get Wisdom of Solomon 17. Listen to this. Verse 1.
This is the book of Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 17, verse 1. For great are thy judgments.
Great is God's judgment, brothers. Laws, statutes, and commandments, that's God's judgment. Come on.
And cannot be expressed.
That cannot be expressed, brothers. Pay attention.
Therefore, unnurtured souls have erred.
Ah. Mm. Come on, man. Where's that bomb there?
Come on, man.
These brothers crazy out here. Come on. Read that thing again, brother.
For great are thy judgments.
Great is God's judgment. Come on.
And cannot be expressed.
That cannot be expressed, brother. Come on.
Therefore, unnurtured souls have erred.
You see that? Therefore, come on.
Unnurtured souls have erred.
Unnourished soul are error and error. Second, Ezra 8 and verse 12, brothers. Let's see what we must do. We just read that the laws of God convert the soul. So we say that a soul with no knowledge, he's gonna do whatever the hell he want. But our job, that's what you remember, where we read before, what the leader is supposed to be doing. Watch over what? Because your soul is always in error if it's not knowledge. You're always going to be in error. Come on, brothers.
2 Ezra chapter 8 and verse 12.
Come on.
Thou broughtest it up with thy righteousness.
Now start at 11.
Verse 11. That the thing which is fashioned may be nourished for a time.
The thing that is fashioned should be nourished for a time is men. Come on.
Till thou dispossess it to thy mercy.
Okay. Because the first nourishment of a man is what, brothers? The first knowledge of a man when he first come in the earth is what?
Mother's milk.
Breast. He familiar with breast. Little breast, skinny breast, big breast, he familiar with that. You understand? That's where he knowledge from. Come on.
That the thing which is fashioned may be nourished for a time.
You see that thing that God was made? He's going to be nourished. Grow up. Come on.
Till thou dispossess it to thy mercy.
And to his disposal to the mercy. Come on.
Thou broughtest it up with thy righteousness.
You brought it up with what?
With righteousness.
Come on.
And nourishes it in thy law.
You see that? The soul must be nourished in God's laws. The same way the body must be nourished with the breast and milk. The soul must be nourished with God's laws, brothers. And if you're not doing that, I'm sorry, brothers. You understand? You may knock out. But brother, never give up. We building you up to be more from mortal to be immortal.
That's right.
It's not gonna be easy, brother, to shake that thing. Read it again for brothers and sisters.
Thou broughtest it up with thy righteousness and nourishest it in thy law.
You see that? God nourish it in thy law. Come on.
And reformest it.
You see that? He reformed that thing. He reformed. That's the word I want you to see. He reformed it. But man can grow up out of breast and milk. But when God reformed it, he changed it. When he started to nourish the soul with laws, he changed the form of it. It changed, brother. It changed. That's why you see that. Y'all remember Saul? When the Spirit of God jumped upon him, what did he become? A new man. That's that transformation. That's that transformation. Come on, my brother.
And reformest it with thy judgment.
You see that thing? He give it judgment. I mean, that's why we are here, trying to get our people right. Because we understand the fight we in is saving our people's soul. You understand? Then we are in the same business with the devil, believe it or not. He's here to destroy soul. We are here to save soul.
That's right.
You understand? So the devil ain't sleeping, so we ain't sleeping.
Right.
You understand?
That's
like
right.
I told the devil when I was teaching on the street, the damn cops. I said, you come here to do your job? We come here to do our job. I said, Joel, show him our job. Maybe he confused. Maybe the cops was confused. You understand? He come to do his job. We come to do our job. So he cannot stop us from doing a job. We cannot stop him from doing his job. Because that's some soul God give to Satan, man. You understand? That's nothing we can do. But there's some soul Satan cannot mess with.
That's right.
You understand? Because they belong to God. Come on, my brother. Captain Halina get me all hyped up here.
Hey, I'm just thinking, man. Y'all ain't see that video? Y'all men see that video? When they was in the Bronx? I looked at it. The deacon had the Spirit of God on him that day. He said, y'all got a job to do. We got a job to do.
Yo, Captain Zakai said, bro, D, I thought we was going to go to jail. Bro, Joel came too, though. Captain Joel came too, man. That's my brother, man. He came too that day. Oh, man, he blew that horn so hard, man. I felt like I was in Kingdom of Heaven. All praise to the Most High, man. Mighty man, mighty man. Yes, sir.
Back to 2 Ezra?
Yeah, let's go back. Let's go back.
2 Ezra chapter 8 and verse 12. Mm-hmm. Thou broughtest it up with thy righteousness, mm-hmm, and nourishest it in thy law.
Nourish it in thy law, come on.
And reformest it with thy judgment.
Reformest it with his judgment, come on.
Verse 13. And thou shalt mortify it as thy creature, mm-hmm, and quicken it as thy work.
You see that thing? It's God that reformed that thing. You see, understand, man need to be reformed. That's what a lot of us don't understand. Let's look at the word again in 2 Ezra. That's 2 Ezra 14. Let me see, 32, 33. Let me see. Mm-hmm. Come on.
The book of 2 Ezra, chapter 14, verse 34.
You see that there?
Therefore, if so be that ye will subdue your own understanding,
uh-huh,
and reform your hearts.
You see that thing? It's the same word, brother. Read that thing again from the beginning.
Therefore, if so be that ye will subdue your own understanding.
What do you mean by subdue your own understanding? Let me see if you're thinking. What do you mean? By subdue your own understanding. What do you mean?
Don't use your own train of thought. You have to use the Lord's train of thought.
Because our thought is what? Let me see if you're thinking. You already know.
Oh, that's the only man in here?
Yeah, man.
You're the only one live in here with a soul in him? What's going on? What's going on with the rest of y'all, brothers?
Yeah, give him back the mic. I guess nobody want it.
Yeah, nobody want it.
He said, I'm right here. Come on, brother. Talk to me.
Psalm Deacon.
Yes, sir.
Our thoughts are carnal.
Yes, our thought. We hardly can think right. Now, let's read the verse again.
2 Ezra chapter 14, verse 34.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, if so be that ye will subdue your own understanding.
Because where do we have our own understanding from? From the white folks. You understand? We got our own understanding from this world. You know what I mean? Full of corruption, full of demonic spirit, full of lust, full of everything. We have our understanding from this world. That's why we must reform. We must reject this world. Because you remember in John, Christ said, if you love the world, that you are what? You are enemy of God. That's what it said. It's clear, ain't it? So we must reform. Come on. How are we going to reform, brothers?
Therefore, if so be that ye will subdue your own understanding.
Uh-huh. Come on.
And reform your hearts.
We must reform our mind, brothers. We must reform our mind the way we have to rethink in things again. You understand? Meaning that adultery have to be rethinking again. Whole monger have to be rethinking again. Thou shalt not steal have to be we thinking again. What about lying? We have to be thinking again because we used to be lying. You understand? We used to be holding. We have to rethink that again. You understand? Come on.
Therefore, if so be that ye will subdue your own understanding.
We must subdue our own understanding. You understand? Our own understanding, brothers, is sin. Is sin. We must humble that thing. Come on.
And reform your hearts.
Because how are we going to reform our heart? By the laws of God. By the statutes and commandment of God. That's all you got there?
There's more, sir. Ye shall be kept alive.
You see that? That's the only way you're going to be kept alive. You must reform. You must reform, brothers. You must reform. That's how you're going to keep alive. Come on.
And after death, ye shall obtain mercy.
After death, you're going to return what?
Mercy.
You're going to return mercy. After death. Come on, Cap.
No, that's saying he said obtain. Is he going to obtain mercy? He's going to give us mercy. You understand? If we subdue our own thoughts and think like God tell us to think and stop thinking like man tell you to think. That's why Deacon always tell you, stop thinking. Because your thoughts was given into you by man.
That's
come
right.
Back to this Bible and think like God told us to think.
Because you know one thing we're going to have to learn? We got to understand how God operates, right? Because, all right, come on. Let's go back to Acts 5.
It's the book of Acts, chapter 5, and verse 24. Now when the high priest and the captain of the temple and the chief priests heard these things, they doubted of them whereunto this would grow. Then came one and told them, saying.
Yeah, I want you to go to 2 Ezra, right? That's how we have to reform. That's why we have to reform. Let's start at 3 and 7.
It's the book of 2 Ezra, chapter 3 and verse 7. And unto him thou gavest commandment to love thy way.
All right.
Which he transgressed.
Mm-hmm.
And immediately thou appointest death in him.
All right. That's what death is appeared to all men, brothers. Pay attention.
And in his generations, of whom came nations, tribes, people, and kindreds out of number.
Mm-hmm. Death was issue. Come on.
And every people walked after their own will.
That's why you have to be transformed. Everybody walk after their own will. You have to reform that. You have to change that. Because you remember in Hebrew, when he said, I come to do thy will, O Lord. You understand? We have to always program our mind to do the will of God. Not our own will. Our own will going to lead us to this. This is our own will. Then guess what? It's us beg the Lord to kill us. When we join gang, we ask the Lord, please kill me. Mm. You understand? When we hang in the club, we ask the Lord, please kill me with HIV, syphilis, all type of diseases. Mm. You understand? When we join gang, we say we want a quick death by the guns, by the knife, stab, everything. We begging the Lord to kill us when we join these things. That's what our own will is. We begging him. But out of his love and mercy, he say, you know what? This nigga ain't right. But I'm gonna lead him the right way. I can use him. All right. Now let's. That's it on that.
Oh, there's more, sir. Verse 8. And every people walked after their own will.
All right.
And did wonderful things before thee.
Uh-huh. Why was that judgment of them? Come on.
And despised thy commandments.
You see that? When you do your own will, you despise God's commandments. That's why we have to listen to leadership, man. That's why I say you cannot think. How would you think when you already know what your mind's capable of doing? Because guess what? You might come up in here, you love a brother or you love a sister. Man, but when they're off, you go, you think that love will bring you back to the world, brother? You think you got so much strong love for the sister. You know that she break the law. You will leave with her? You think you have so much love for the brother. He break the law. You think you will willing to bounce with him? There's no such a love, brother. It's only in your mind. Come on.
That's it. One verse 9.
Yeah, come on, come on.
Verse 9. And again, in process of time, thou broughtest the flood upon those that dwelt in the world.
Yeah, but why he bring the flood, brother? Why you think he bring the flood? We just read it. Why he bring the flood? Don't give it to them. They start to follow their own will. So God said, I'm going to flood the thing. I mean, when they transgress, why did he bring death? Now, when they're continuing their will, he bring the flood, judgment. Come on.
And again, in process of time, thou broughtest the flood upon those that dwelt in the world and destroyedest them.
Mm-hmm.
And it came to pass in every of them that as death was to Adam
for breaking the commandment. Come on.
So was the flood to these.
You see that? Death was a judgment, so is the flood was a judgment. Come on.
Nevertheless, one of them thou leftest, namely Noah.
You see that? God always preserves something. You see, he said, one of them, but you left. Come on.
Noah with his household, of whom came all righteous men.
Because he was a righteous man. And read it again, brother.
Nevertheless, one of them thou leftest, namely Noah with his household.
That's like when you look at the one west, right? Like you look at the school of one west, the Lord preserved Bishop Netanyahu. Huh? Yeah, I mean, he said, you know what? That's one of them I'm going to pick. Right. You understand? Then he's going to wise up the people. He's going to teach the people laws, statutes, and commandments. They're gonna reform.
That's
but
right.
Our people, when you look at our people, the condition we in, nobody believe we can reform. They say, these niggas crazy. I'm going to show you that I don't believe we can reform. Give me the two videos about the rap. One of them about the sister. Then we're going to play the rap right after that. The brother about the hip-hop is right after that. You're going to play her first, then you're going to. You remember I had your delete, then I sent your two. No, you're going to see the sister. Yeah. Cool. This one first. Then get ready for the next one, hip-hop. Come on.
How do you feel about your culture and what they do with music?
I think it's a part of it. It's a part, and I've talked about this on my show, who owns these record label companies? Who signs a Sexy Red? You can go out and you can buy, you can get any
white
artist
people
in the world.
White people sign. White people behind our demise. White people trying to destroy us. Not try. Look at what they're doing. They've been succeed. But guess what? Brothers, you're wise up to prove them wrong. Come on, man.
Based on their talent. Why is that when you come to Black America, you want to platform someone like Sexy Red when it used to be you platform people like Lauryn Hill?
I want you guys, bring it back all the way back, because there's something in it I miss. Come on.
How do you feel about your culture and what they do with music?
I think it's a part of it. It's
a
part.
This. Y'all catch something? Read it, bring it back again.
How do you feel about your culture and what they do with
you
music?
You see that? Your culture. Rap music is not our culture. Keep God. What do you think about your culture? No, this is our culture right here.
That's right.
The commitment of God. Come on.
I think it's a part of it. It's a part, and I've talked about this on my show. Who owns these record label companies? Who signs a Sexy Red? You can go out and you can get any artist in the world based on their talent. Why?
Stop it. You remember she said, who owned this record labels, right? The next video, don't put it on yet. We're going to finish with her. The next video is going to show you who behind these things. Come on.
Why is that when you come to Black America, mm-hmm. you want to platform someone like Sexy Red mm-hmm. when it used to be you platform people like Lauryn Hill? This is intentional because... You know, as Confucius said, a Chinese philosopher said that, you know, what is in your ears will eventually
manifest,
be what surrounds you, right? Yeah. Music is very.
Because, brothers, I want you guys to understand, our condition didn't come overnight. Our condition been planted for years. We've been programmed to get where we are today. But white people will tell you to move on. But, brother, we need real therapy. Some of us, I'm going to show you. how I know we need will therapy. Give me Deuteronomy 28, 28. We need will therapy, man. Yeah, I think I was watching a class this week about, who was that? Oh, that was some dope thing. That was some good stuff. Who was that? Yeah, go ahead.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 28. The Lord shall smite thee with madness and blindness and astonishment of heart.
That people need some type of therapy. That's the people you see in all your street today. We really need will therapy, man. Mm. But the only the word of God able to reform us, man, and get us in the right frame of mind.
That's right.
You understand? Now you got me? Come on. Who is this? Yeah, man, now, you remember what she said earlier, right? Listen to this man. Yeah, listen to my man right here. That's what we must reform. Come on.
Changing from positive to negative was not a consequence of history. It was not a circumstance of history. It was nothing that just happened on its own. It had nothing to do with the changing of the times. It had nothing to do with that. It had everything to do with the fact that there are people in this particular society who wants to see us exactly where we are. I believe it was JT, the bigger figure, who said the label executives came to him and said, yo, brother, we need you talking about guns and whores. You know what I mean?
That's right.
That happens. I've been in those meetings. Young Buck, he has a song on his album that talks about police terrorism. The label said absolutely not. Jimmy Iovine said absolutely
you
not.
See that? He finally give you the name. They usually say, they, them. I mean, we have so much fear, man. We usually say, they, them. Why don't you just say white people earn the label? Now he finally realized he just said that so-called Jews, call themselves Jews. Come on.
He has a song on his album.
Yeah, went a little bit back so we can hear the name of so-called Jews he mentioned.
Who said the label executives came to him and said, yo, brother, we need you talking about guns and whores.
Right.
You know what I mean?
That's right.
That happens. I've been in those meetings. Young Buck, he has a song on his album that talks about police terrorism. The label said absolutely not. Jimmy Iovine said absolutely not. You cannot put that on the album because
yeah, y'all, it might y'all heard that name, brother? That brother right here. Let y'all see the name? Put that name there. We can bring a picture to the name. Come on, man, because y'all slow back there. I'm going to help y'all. I'm going to help y'all, brothers. You're my brothers. I'm going to help y'all. All right? We got to put a picture to the name, brother. You know? Because our people like to say they, them. No. We ain't about they, them here. I mean, we're going to quote the name and show the picture. Yep. And let's look at... Yeah, this is the devil.
That's right.
You understand? This is Satan himself in the black community.
That's
you understand?
Right.
Talking about what my man say? What? Culture. Our culture. You know what I mean? They're in there. Yep. What he have to do with our culture? You understand? That's what the same, what's that, Jonathan Green, blah, whatever his name is, he going to go to the, what's that show? Yeah, Breakfast Club, Yemen, like he's a part of the black community. Now, nobody want to see you. Come on. You see that? These dudes, they're everywhere. I mean, they're everywhere. Then our people sell their soul to them, man. See, they don't want these rappers to sing about uplifting our people. They want them to sing about hoes and bitches. Excuse my language.
That's right.
You understand? That's what my brother just said. Then we've been in this world. We know these type of music co-op soul, brothers. Co-op mind, brothers. You know, like the Biggie Small song, when he said, when he had that, there was a little, he's out here to feed his daughter. You remember
juicy,
that song?
Juicy.
Yeah, until today, if you heard that thing in the music, you have to check yourself. Because there's a beat to it. You understand? That messing with your mind, man. That messing with your soul. You understand? But that nigga was talking about wicked things, man. He want to murder other people to feed his kids and his son and his daughter. We defile as a people. We foul. That's why Deuteronomy 28 we just read. You know what I mean? We really need therapy. But now let's go back. Let's go back where we at. For time's sake, where we at?
Acts chapter 5.
Mm-hmm. Let's go to Acts chapter 5.
That's the book of Acts chapter 5 and verse 24.
Come on, man.
Now when the high priest and the captain of the temple and the chief priests heard these things, they doubted of them whereunto this would grow.
You see that? They doubted. No, no. This thing ain't going to nowhere. These Israelite stuff, we ain't going nowhere with it. But brothers, I want you to see that. Have we not gone anywhere? Brothers, you remember the thing I call you, person to tell you. You know, the Isaiah. You remember I told you, get me the video. You got me? All right? They're saying that. Read that verse again. Now these dumb Christians said, this Israelite stuff ain't going nowhere. Let's see what God said.
Now, when the high priest and the captain of the temple and the chief priest heard these things, they doubted of them whereunto this would grow.
He said, that's it. This thing ain't going to grow. This Israelite stuff ain't going to grow. Come on, play this thing here. And line him up, line me up with one or two of them. Come on.
Israel united in Christ, from corners to countries, gathering the 12 tribes of Israel. We going to take the world.
Hey, Most High in Christ, bless Israel, Bishop of
that. Yeah, I thought that saying, I thought that said we ain't going nowhere with it.
That's right.
Now let's see if we had not been going anywhere. Come on, brother, pay.
Appreciate that term, but today we're going to find out if I'm a true general or not.
في متى 28 أمر المسيح بالتأديب اذهبوا إلى كل الأمم وعمدوهم باسم الآب والابن والروح القدس وعلمهم أن ينتبهوا بغض النظر عما أوصيك بفعله كما نعلم فإن 12 قبيلة من إسرائيل كما قال يعقوب 1 و 1 منتشرة في جميع أنحاء العالم جميع البلدان.
Yeah, yeah. Mute that for a second. Give me that sub 19. You know what I want to do, right? Two. Yeah. Now the words go to what the. Yeah. Now I play that video.
جنوب الصحراء الكبرى إلى تجارة الرقيق عبر المحيط الأطلسي. حسنا. سنتعامل مع ذلك. Das Evangelium wurde überall gepredigt. Doch es gibt noch viel zu tun. Okay, hinzu. Korintherbrief Kapitel 10, rund um Vers 16. Ich glaube, Paulus hat gesagt, man solle das Evangelium in Regionen jenseits seiner selbst predigen und sich nicht mit der Arbeit anderer Männer rühmen. Wir wollen nicht damit prahlen, dass kein anderes Lager so hoch arbeitet, dass wir auf eine Mission berufen werden. Wir müssen diese Mission erfüllen. Kapitäns, Offizieren, Soldaten, um Obtestan, in Jesef, wadigte Tonen, wurde diese Wahrheit. Okay, dus wat ikka du en ikka je itzlaten sin. Yoku kite, kono chizuo miseru.
We don't have people in Japan, Cap?
Yeah, sir.
Come on, man, we don't have people in German? Yeah, I thought they said they ain't going to anything. Come on, man.
Kutsuka no gaku arimasu. Amerika no itaru tokoro ni mo aru. Takaki kami ni kansha shimasu.
Y'all guys don't understand. We're going to hunt our people wherever they go. Because we believe, let's get James 1 in 1, brother. We believe in this thing right here. We're going to hunt our people wherever they're at. Because our job is to make sure we gather the soul of the 12 tribes. That's our job. That's why we send deacon and captain to all their regions, officers, soldiers. Read that verse.
It's the book of James, chapter 1, verse 1. James, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Come on, man.
To the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad, greeting.
Are we not doing that right now, brother? When you put me on, guess where we at? We in many people country. Many people. We greeting our people with the word of God.
That's right.
Read it again, brothers.
James, a servant of God. And of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Come on.
To the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad.
The 12 tribes that scattered abroad, brothers. Come on.
Greeting.
We all greeting you. Come on.
My. That's,
come on. Now let's go back to the video.
No tenemos ninguna base todavía aquí. Entiende, no tenemos fundamento. Tenemos enseñanzas, pero ningún fundamento. El Altísimo nos acaba de permitir abrir una escuela aquí en Ecuador. Pero escucha, mira, no tenemos fundamento en estas áreas.
See, some what I want you to understand, some place we not yet, but is a open invitation. What's the word? Is a open
invitation.
Yes, the bishop has opened for your brother. Get your passport for you. Get yourself ready for these battles, man, because we have to conquer these places that we had not been yet. But you are here. I think me and Malachi was talking earlier this week. Because a lot of times, you see COVID, you see that thing that happened in COVID? You see, a man that have wisdom, he going to think. I say, damn. If that thing will go down the time of COVID, a lot of us was not prepared. You understand? Now you see that. There was a warning. Now you see me how bishops say, yo, we have to, you guys have to wise up and go through these country teach, right? But this is what I want your leaders to understand, right? I want your leaders to understand something, all right? Finish that a little bit. I want your guys.
Está bien, tenemos algunas enseñanzas, pero ningún fundamento. Sin fundamento, necesitamos llegar a toda Argentina y Chile. Shule kadha katika bara la Afrika kutoa sifa zote kadhalika walio juu zaidi kadhalika hilo shule kadha tunazo hapa lakini hiyo haitoshi.
Remember what we just read about Peter. What happened to Peter? Then he had to do what? All right? I want your guys to focus on that thing for a minute or two, right? But as we travel through all these countries, right? We establish camp. We put little sanctuary in these places, right? Satan gonna come in full force, right? Then if you're not prepared here, because some of us, we see all these economy, how the economy right now is glorious to brothers that have houses. The brother that just buy a house for 150, now his house is probably worth 450. That's a brother that's gonna be comfort. He don't understand the time he's in. You're thinking about you buying something for 150, right? And that thing worth 450. Would you not saying wisdom would tell you, you know what? I got to get something, at least to build something for myself. I don't hold nothing in that. These are wisdom. But a man don't have no wisdom, guess what? That thing weighs up to 400, 600. Then when they come down, boop, to zero, you see the brother being afflicted. Maybe that's not the truth. Maybe I have to work double time. Maybe I have to work overtime. Brother, you did not prepare. Because a prepared brother, a prepared sister gonna look at the time. This thing here is so much money. Like I was listening to this wife, but he said, listen, you can print money these days, which is true. You understand? Everything sky high. But we're not thinking now. We're not thinking. It's the same thing about what's that thing, that so-called that token that there was a higher price? Well, Bitcoin. There's brother that lose 300, 400, 1,000. You understand? Because they was not prepared. You know, some brothers don't prepare. You know, the scripture said, the earth is given to the hands of the wicked, right? They understand the white man is wicked, right? But when they get to finance, he watches. That thing don't make no sense to me. Make it make sense to me, man. Make it make sense to me. When they get to finance, he watches. But we read Job, the earth is given to the hands of wicked men, right? That's interesting. Very interesting. Make it make sense to me, brothers.
That's a set up, bro.
Make it make sense to me. Come on, brother, read.
Back to Acts 5?
Yes. No, what I asked you for, what Bishop just did, let's read it in a psalm.
Yes.
So then I need the next video that I asked you. Yeah, you got it? German. Yeah, when you got people in German, people in Japan talk, yeah, all but I need that.
The book of Psalms, chapter 19, verse 3.
Start at 2.
Verse 2. Mm-hmm. Day unto day uttereth speech, and night unto night showeth knowledge.
Come on, man.
There is no speech nor language where their voice is not heard.
Now, I play my video up there. Then y'all understand these scriptures? We're going to bring these scriptures to life.
That's right.
That's what we do in IUIC. We bring the Bible to life, where you cannot deny us what we are. Back. We back, brothers, plus we black. The prophet is back, then plus we black.
That's right.
You better get used to us.
That's right.
Then some of us light skin too. You know? I know the white man said, damn, I cannot pull the racist card. Some of them look light. They're very light. Captain Shim, I ain't talking about you, man. Deacon Joshua, I ain't talking about you. Come on, man.
Got it.
Damn, y'all take that long to pull out the video, man. I call for it. Yeah, come on. Read that verse again.
Day unto day, art of speech.
Uh-huh.
And night unto night, show of knowledge.
Uh-huh.
There is no speech nor language where their voice is not heard.
You see that these prophets' voice will be heard in every country.
Right.
Let's get the one in Ezekiel, little century. Is that, let me see if I can remember. Is that 12, 16? 11 out there. I was on there this week. I like that. I can remember this thing.
It's the book of Ezekiel, chapter 11 and verse 16. Therefore say, thus saith the Lord God.
This is what God said. That's not man now. Pay attention, brothers.
Although I have cast them far off among the heathen.
Because we've been cast off among the heathen. We just read it in James 1. Greeting to all our brothers who've been scattered throughout the world. Come on.
And although I have scattered them among the countries.
Yes, we just read it in James. We've been scattered throughout the country. Come on, man.
Yet will I be to them as a little sanctuary.
You see that? God said he will be to us like a little sanctuary. That's what we do here in our UIC. We build this little sanctuary. Same thing the apostle was doing is the same thing we're doing today. But I thought that said, Cap, that thing ain't going to go through nothing. That means the devil is a liar.
That's right.
Damn, the devil is a liar. Come on, y'all ready for me or still? Y'all good? All right, wherever you, just put it down.
Ninja.
They say we ain't gonna mount to nothing. Listen, look at this. That's Jupain. Yeah, they're showing you brothers teaching to all that things. That's the video we had. Come on, brothers. Come on, man. Y'all got to stay in the spirit back there. You're supposed to have these things in folder. I call you. Before I get there, I call you. Come on, man. You got to stay in the spirit. Maybe you're thinking about sex or something. Mine might. Right. Come on.
Little sanctuaries.
Yeah, read that.
Ezekiel 11, verse 16. Therefore say, thus saith the Lord God, although I have cast them far off among the heathen, and although I have scattered them.
I think they have to do with Isaiah 11, brothers, where there was every country preaching. Come on, man. You act like you're lost back there. Come on. Come on, read.
And although I have scattered them among the countries, yet will I be to them as a little sanctuary.
A little sanctuary.
In the countries where they shall come.
All right. Now let's go back to Acts. To these brothers find that video I'm looking for. Come on.
Book of Acts chapter 5 and verse 24.
Mm-hmm.
Now when the high priest and the captain of the temple and the chief priests heard these things, they doubted of them whereunto this would grow. Then came one and told them, saying, behold, the men whom ye put in prison are standing in the temple and teaching the people.
You see that thing? It's clear and crystal, man. Come on.
Then came one and told them, saying, behold, the men whom ye put in prison are standing in the temple and teaching the people. Then went the captain with the officers and brought them without violence, for they feared the people, lest they should have been stoned. And when they had brought them, they set them before the council. And the high priest asked them.
Because what I want your guys to understand, they're going to be angry when they see our people being repent. We just read earlier in chapter 4 was 5,000. Chapter 2 was 3,000. So we growing. You understand? In this modern day, we are growing so fast.
That's
I think before that thing happened, the so-called COVID, we was building school every month, two, three school everything. The Satan just come bang. But we still, even though with that COVID time, we still had 10,000 visitors. That's showing you that we doing the work, brothers. But a lot of them, the Lord is not showing us. We be too prideful. There's some people that's doing it. You understand? The Lord lining us up for good. Come on, y'all got it? No? Y'all don't find it yet? All right, come on.
Saying, did not we straightly command you that ye should not teach in this name?
You see that? They're trying to stop these apostles that was waking up people. 5,000, 3,000. That said, don't teach in the name. Because they was afraid the people that used to believe in them, leaving them, go follow the apostles. You understand? Come on.
And behold, ye have filled Jerusalem with your doctrine and intend to bring this man's blood upon us.
Let's get John 11, 47.
The book of John.
And we're going to go right back to Acts. Finish that up right quick.
Yes, sir. It's the book of Acts, John chapter 11, verse 47. Then gathered the chief priests and the Pharisees a council and said, what do we? For this man doeth many miracles.
Talking about Christ. Come on.
If we let him thus alone.
If we leave this man alone here.
All men will believe on him.
All men will believe in him. Guess what? We will not make our money. That's the mindset. Everybody will believe in him. Guess what? We ain't going to make no money. Because that's what men think about. Covetous Pharisees. You understand? The kid that was saying it about Christ, they're saying it the same thing about the apostle.
Right.
Because we just read about the apostle was doing the same great works. Right? Come on, finish that up.
And the Romans shall come and take away both our place and nation.
You see what they're thinking about, brothers? Read it again. So I want y'all guys to see the mindset of these wicked Pharisees, man. Come on.
If we let him thus alone.
If we let that man alone to heal our people, you understand? Save soul of our people. Come on.
All men will believe on him.
All men will believe in him. That's the right thing to do. Come on.
And the Romans shall come and take away both our place.
You see that? That's all they think about. The white man going to put hell on us. Because the woman were white people. The Greeks were white people. The woman was white people. But they said, we don't want the white man to destroy us, to mess up their economy, to do this, to do that. You're going to find out it's the same thing going to happen here in these modern days, man.
That's right.
Our people going to do the same thing. This never fail. All they worry about is what?
Money.
Their gain. Their gain. They ain't care about the people. All that way about is their gain. It's their gain. Come on.
And the Romans shall come and take away both our place.
You see that? They're going to take both our place and where we live, the money we made, the ledger we got. They're going to come take over everything. But God already see it in the spirit. 70 AD happened. God said, don't worry. I got a remedy for you. You worry about Rome, I got you. Come on.
Both take away our place and nation.
Mm-hmm. That's where they think. That's where they mind at. Now let's go back to Acts. Yes, sir. Because you remember the reason we've been Isaiah 11. They're saying that this thing ain't going to grow. We just read that in Acts. Let's read it again in Acts 5 and 24. We got the mindset.
Acts chapter 5, verse 24. Now when the high priest and the captain of the temple and the chief priests heard these things, they doubted of them whereunto this would grow. Then came one and told them, saying, behold, the men whom he put in prison are standing in the temple and teaching the people.
See, they get angry of them, right? They're saying that this thing is not going to grow. Right?
Yes, sir.
Listen to this. Now play my video up.
Come pass in that day
that the Lord shall set his hand again, the second time, to recover the remnant of his people.
It's you who don't know. It's you Afro-Syrians who don't know your history.
And going to the other side of India, you see the Dalits as well as the Sindhis. Same thing on the Eastern Hemisphere. Mass incarceration, police brutality, lynchings, convict leasings.
Yeah, but Prendat, then we are in India. You understand? Right. We ain't just talk the talk, we walk the walk, brothers. And clap your hand for yourself, brothers and sisters. Clap your hand for yourself. We ain't talk the talk, we walk the walk too.
That's right.
Come on.
Those are cities, same thing on the Eastern Hemisphere. Mass incarceration, police brutality, lynchings, convict leasings.
You brothers and sisters in South Sudan, your heritage goes far deeper than where you live. You are the children of God.
That's the Congo. That's Germany. Come on. That's Japan. You see that? These things reach to all that Arab country as well, brothers. Don't let Satan fool you. Because the scripture said in Psalm 19, we just read it. You understand? Then we just read in Ezekiel, you know what I mean? They're going to be little sanctuary. That's what we're doing here. So you know, like a lot of times when we said to the clubhouse, now what's that thing? Booster club, right? Then y'all see where your money's at. Because we don't only walk, we all talk, we are doing it, brothers. We are doing it. You understand? We've been traveling, bringing these words to our people, wherever our people are, we're going to reach that. That's if the Lord right. will. And then there's also that I want your brothers to understand about, yeah, also Passover is the same thing. You see, man, Passover, what we're doing this year, we allowed our people, we allowed us, the region, to stand around the regions, right? Then we're sending leaders to you. Don't think why we, you have to think why we're doing this. Why we doing this is for us to do what? I mean, who can help us there? Let me see if you're always there when Bishop was talking, the deacon was talking. Who can help us? Why are we doing this Passover locally this time? So I want your guys to have the mind, like, because Israel easy to forgive quick. They forget quick. So I want your guys to have the mindset.
Hey, Shalom, Deacon.
Hey, how you doing, fam?
Good. To have our own land.
You cooking with fire, young man. Say it loud, man, with confidence.
To have our own land.
All right, that's why we're doing it, brothers and sisters. So instead of like spending thousand-something dollars to get the Passover, but you can put the money in the side and send it for the land. Right. So next time, we ain't going to rent from nobody. Right. So we will have our own. Right. Because I know Israel, as soon as they start partying, they forget what they party for. Because sometimes that party get to my head too. I be doing my thing. Man, but I want your guys to focus. It's the same thing about the new movies as well, brothers. You understand? That's because you give. That's why you allowed us to start. I think I was talking to the bishop. I said, it's a good thing, man, that you know what I mean, that the Lord did not bless us with a lot of money where we start the big productions of movies. But hey, we start so little so we can earn it. When you start little, you earn the product. You understand? That means you can start all over again. You still will build it whatever you want. But when you start big, then now you fail. You don't know what the hell to do. But when you start little, then now you build it to be a successful company. Guess what? You know it from step one, step two. That's like any company. Understand that. Now we like what? 15 minutes? You understand? What is that? 30 minutes, Lord's will, we be hours. We be hour and a half. We be 2 hours. Then you're going to get tired of us. It's too long now. That's the water wise, and it's too long. But that's all right. We get the best producer. We get the best movie director. Yeah. We got the best music producer. We got it all at IUIC, man.
That's right.
You understand? The Lord bless us with good brothers here. Come on,
hey,
fam.
Dick, but you know what, Dick? And it's good because everybody feel like they're a part of it mm-hmm. when they donate to Matthew 2:13.
Uh-huh.
When y'all donate to Matthew 2:13, we all is being a part of this great awakening. You understand? It's not just a one- or two-man effort. It's a congregational or a nationwide, you understand, building of our people. You understand? All praise. Make sure y'all donating too to that Matthew 2:13.
Yes, man. I wanna address that so hard because I want your brothers to understand how it's gonna be when you have your own. Nobody can come and tell you how to go home. Because your brothers don't understand that. Because I remember when we was first, you remember we was in Brooklyn. Yeah. We didn't have our own. I mean, like, they used to knock, hey, yo, your guys have to go. We went to Bronx. Yeah. Then there was a tenor upstairs, and we got to go. Then guess what? Many, many, many events, many hotels, they tell us we got to go. But when you earn your own, brothers, you put your mark in it, then nobody can tell you a damn thing. Yeah, that's why we trying to build your mind. To be focused on. You understand? Don't look at the Passover. It's us trying to buy the land. You understand? To build our own. So please, brothers and sisters, let's focus. Let's focus. Don't forget that. Let's focus. Yeah, I mean, we send captains. We send deacons. We send officers. Yep. You know what I mean, man? To entertain you, Passover. You understand? Please, brothers, remember what the mission is for. Don't give up on us. We need to have our own. All right? Come on, brothers.
Back to Acts 5.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Acts chapter 5, verse 24.
Oh, yeah, yeah. No, no. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on, man. Finish that video up. Finish that thing up right here.
Wie français? Laat je niet misleiden van onze people.
Yes. Then you notice that, you know what I mean? Like, yeah, yeah, you notice that these countries, right, that our brother is able to speak their language. That's like Acts 2. You remember Acts 2 when the Holy Spirit come upon them? Yeah, you understand? It's the same thing is happening today. You understand? As we build men up, some of them speak Spanish, hit the Spanish region. Some of them teaching English, hit the English region. You understand? Because these things, when we say Southern Kingdom, Northern Kingdom, you think that we come up with Southern Kingdom, Northern Kingdom? We don't come up with that thing. Let's get that in Joshua, man. I think you're playing around too much. Mm-hmm. We say Northern Kingdom, Southern Kingdom. I say, where you get that from? I think it's in Joshua. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Joshua 18:5.
It's the book of
because when you're looking at go to Romans, I think 8, when it mentioned the house of Judah, the house of Israel. That's who the Bible is for. So don't get it confused, brother. If you find yourself confused, go back to the basic. Basic will help you strongly. Come on. Is that 8 or 10? I think it's 8. It's eight, is it what? Go ahead. The Northern Kingdom. I'll put, it said the covenant with the house of Israel, with the house of Judah. Hey, what did I say? Oh, damn, man. You know, I thought I speak. Then my language was off.
It's the book of Hebrews, chapter 8 and verse 8. For finding fault with them, he saith, behold, the days come, saith the Lord, when I will make a new covenant.
When I will do what?
Make a new covenant
uh-huh.
with the house of Israel
uh-huh.
and with the house of Judah.
With the house of Israel, with the house of Judah, the new covenant, the Bible is with the house of Israel, the house of Judah. That's where the covenant, God will make the covenant, which is Christ, yes. with our people. All right? So I want you to understand that when we really say Northern Kingdom, Southern Kingdom, you don't think that we're just saying it out of our own thought. Let's read it like in Joshua 8:18, I think it's 5. Come on. See, everything is fine in the Bible, brothers. That's why you need to read and understand. Come on.
It's the book of Joshua, chapter 18, verse 5.
Mm-hmm.
And they shall divide it into 7 parts.
Mm-hmm.
Judah shall abide in their coast on the south.
And Judah gonna hold what side, brothers? South. Come on, brother.
And the house of Joseph shall abide in the coast on the north.
So what happened to the Northern Kingdom? Where they're going to hold down? The north. So you see when they say Northern Kingdom, Southern Kingdom, brother, is right here in the scripture. Don't get it confused. The prophet is awake. I want your guys to understand that. But I want your guys to understand something, though. Time is killing us, but we're going to jump right quick. All right? I want you to read, yeah, man, where you was at in Acts 5?
524.
Let's jump to 30. 30. We're going to read 30 and 31 right quick for time's sake.
Acts chapter 5 and verse 31. Mm-hmm. Him hath God exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior, for to give repentance to Israel.
That Christ was to give repentance to Israel. That's what the death of Christ is all about. The giving repentance to Israel. So we may repent out of sin. Guess what? That we may receive the kingdom. That was always promised to us. Come on.
And forgiveness of sins.
Uh-huh.
Verse 32. And we are his witnesses of these things.
We are his witnesses of these things, brothers. So is you. You are the witnesses of these things. Come on.
And so is also the Holy Ghost.
So he's also the Holy Spirit that God gives to us, right? I want y'all guys to focus on something, right? You remember we read about how the Pharisee was grievous when they put their hands on the apostles? I'm going to show y'all guys something. Yeah, give me first. This is what we have to exhort y'all when y'all hit these streets. Y'all are thinking this is a walking in the park. All right, 1 Thessalonians 3. And your mortal body, you know what I mean? You're going to find out there's a lot you're going to have to conquer. There's a lot you're going to have to overcome. Come on.
It's the book of 1 Thessalonians, chapter 3, verse 1. Mm-hmm. Wherefore, when we could no longer forbear, we thought it good to be left at Athens alone and sent Timotheus, our brother and the minister of God.
Because Paul was doing the same thing we're doing today. We send brothers to our region, to the different country. Paul was doing the same thing. Timothy went, come on.
And our fellow laborer.
Our fellow laborer, come on.
In the gospel of Christ.
Yeah, because that brother was putting in a lot of labor, brothers. Y'all have to put a lot of labors in. You understand? Your sister's the same. Come on.
To establish you and to comfort you concerning your faith.
You see me what the labor is for, brothers? Let's read it again. Some brothers still sleeping.
In the gospel of Christ, to establish you.
To do what?
Establish you.
The labor is to do what? It's for you, brothers and sisters. It's for you. We laboring for you. Come on.
And to comfort you concerning your faith.
Concerning your faith. Come on.
That no man should be moved by these afflictions.
You see that? No man should be moved by these afflictions. What is affliction is referring to? Let's look at the word affliction right quick. You see? Because a lot of people see the word affliction. Because we are going to go through it. None of us going to escape the affliction. I want you guys to understand that. None of us going to escape the tribulation. You understand? None of us, we're going to see some type of, we're going to feel it. Come on.
Affliction. Something that causes pain or suffering.
Yeah, jump to like, when I say suffering, distress, yeah, for time's sake.
Suffering, distress, pain, trouble, misery, hardship, misfortune.
Yeah, you see what the scripture said, brothers, about hardship. As what? As a soldier, the hard. We have to endure that thing, come on.
Hardship, misfortune, adversity, sorrow. Torment.
See that? Torment, brothers. That might take your nails off. Or cut your nose off. Or cut your ears off. Bro, where your leader at? Clop. I go, clop. We going to go through that thing, brothers. You should not be amazed by that.
Right.
Because it's only happening where, brother? It's only happening to your flesh. That pain, you can sustain the pain, trust me. Because God said he would not give you what? More. So you must believe that thing.
That's right.
You better build that. You better build your spirit to that. Yeah, you know, like how you in the world, man, how a young man try to be a man, he go. You better build yourself to that. Hype yourself up. Come on.
Affliction. Adversity, sorrow, torment, tribulation.
Tribulation, brother.
Calamity, ordeal, ills, trouble,
evil.
I want brother to understand. Their affliction, right? The Lord say affliction, right? That can their affliction be a part and you get sick? What's your thing? If a brother or sister gets sick, is that a part of the affliction? Why is a part of it? Let me see if you're thinking. Help me here. Yeah, come on, brother in the back. I'm going to help you. Read that verse again. There's something in the verse supposed to help you.
1 Thessalonians 3 and verse 3. That no man should be moved by these afflictions.
Mm-hmm.
For yourselves know that we are appointed thereunto.
Y'all guys, y'all understand what he said? You was appointed. That means that should not be amazed to you. That should not be a shock to you. Because that's what the Lord said you was going to have it. That you was appointed to go through what you're going through right now. It's not a coincidence you're going through it. That's not a coincidence Paul went through what he's going through. That's not a coincidence Peter went through what he's going through. That's not a coincidence why brother going through what they're going through. You must go on through things. Because that was already written for you to go through them. Come on. Come on, help me, brother.
It's like, what's that scripture? Is it gold is tried in the fire?
Uh-huh.
So you got to go through these things to purge the negative things out of you, like certain things out of you. Like, say, if you're a sinner, if you got a lot of lust on your mind or being gay or something like that. So God's going to purge that stuff out of you. You go through.
I say ill. Explain to me about ill.
Ill?
Sick. A brother sick or like, sister sick.
Okay, for instance,
what they like, got to do with affliction? Explain to me so I know you understand.
They
got
to endure that affliction. They got to go through it.
Yeah. Why they have to endure it?
That way you could be saved that then.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So you endure that.
Imagine you sitting in a hospital bed, right?
Yeah.
So what's going to come in your head? Why they're saying that the affliction of sickness, why I'm saying that to you? Because why you laying in the bed, guess what's going to come in your thought?
The devil.
Yeah, but what you mean?
He's going to come into you trying to say that you can't do it. God don't care about you. And
okay, brother. Oh, boy, you cooking with fire, brother. Yes. That's good. But because that's when the trial come. You know what I mean? The devil in your ear said, I thought you were Israelite. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Why God ain't healing you then? Mm-hmm. Why God ain't doing this to you? Why you like this? Why you like that? Like a sister is saying that. Why I'm plagued? But all these things, you came from a world of wickedness. You better get it together. Pray the Lord Bible, he sent a man that can heal the disease. Mm-hmm. Talking about why is this, why is that? Now you start doubting yourself why you in the hospital bed. You start doubting yourself why you in a car accident. You start doubting yourself why you losing the house. You start doubting yourself why you lose the wife. You start doubting yourself why you losing your husband. You start doubting why you losing your wife, kids, children, uncles. You start doubting yourself. I mean, you think it's the truth. Come on, brother. Read.
1 Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 3, that no man should be moved by these afflictions.
Because?
For yourselves know that we are appointed thereunto.
Y'all understand what he's saying? We should not hurt from any brother. This is what I heard brother say. The reason I did not show up to the Sabbath, I said, I got Sabbath sickness. And brother said, I got some problem. Yeah. I was going through things. Oh, brother, I had a little cold. Brother, I had a little runny nose. Like, you have none of runny nose, brother. You might just drink. Me, I got one. If I drink something cold, my nose runny. That don't mean I got a cold. But a brother will drink something early in the morning. Say, damn, I can justify myself. My nose is really running. So I'm not lying. I do have a runny nose. I don't want to have nobody sick. Brother, you just cool. You just drink a cold things, brother. Stop playing game. You understand? Or their brothers, or their sister, every Sabbath, they're sick. Satan enter to the body, say, brother, you sick. You don't need to be on the body. During the whole week, their brother jumping, joppy jack, whatever the hell he's doing in his life. You understand? But when he comes to the Sabbath, he confused. He already know he ain't going to make it to the Sabbath since it's Wednesday. But brother, it's Wednesday. You got Thursday to go. Then you got Friday morning. The Lord can heal all that. Got to think, brothers. Think, man. Don't let Satan enter. Come on.
That no man should be moved by these afflictions.
Yeah, I want you guys to understand, right? Yeah. All right. These affliction can be like you see somebody be put to death, right? Then if you know you was appointed, that brother was appointed to be put to death. So what is your comfort to his other brother as a leader? What's going to be your word of comfort? Who can help us say it? They're saying that we was appointed to this thing, right? Then you see a brother being put to death in camp. So what is your word of comfort to these brothers? That's what we just read right there. That brother was appointed to death, man. Let's go, move on. We got to move on.
That's right.
You understand? That the comfort word is for us to move on. You understand? Your brother, shake it off, man. Let's move on. Next block. You understand? Next city, next country is because we was appointed to death. You understand? Let's get that. That thing pop up when Paul said, the apostle that we was appointed, something Paul said, I forgot. Almost yes, familiar
First
with that.
1 Corinthians 4:9.
Yes, you know what I'm talking about? Yeah, yes, let's get that.
1 Corinthians 4:9.
Mm-hmm.
For I think that God has set forth us, the apostles, last.
Why?
As it were appointed to death.
You see that? You see that, brother? It's clear. It's crystal. Priest up upon priest up here a little, there a little. Don't get scared. Mm. Just take the death. Take the cross. Take the death. Hey, what's wrong with you?
You got me. Give me a 2 Ezra 7:57. 2 Ezra 7:57.
It's the book of 2 Ezra 7:57.
Go ahead.
Then answered he me and said, this is the condition of the battle.
This is what we got to go through. We got to go through these things and come out unscathed. Mm. That's what the Lord telling us. We have to go through these things if you are a man of the Lord. Go ahead.
This is the condition of the battle which man that is born upon earth shall fight.
That's what you appointed to. You got to fight like hell in this truth right here. It ain't going to be given to you.
That's right.
You understand? This condition of battle, whatever you go through, if it's sickness, if you being about to be put to death, whatever it is for this truth, that's the condition of the battle that God gave you that you got to carry out.
That's right.
You understand?
Yes, sir.
You got to carry out. If your brother get killed, you got to go to that corner, and you got to stand strong for him. This battle don't stop.
It's just like, it's cold to say it, brother, because that didn't happen. It have not happened yet. But, and you know, like it's just like you in the army. You find out your man is dead right in front of you. What you going to do? Trying to pick him up and get a bullet in your head, or you keep it moving? You got to keep it moving, man. This is what this truth is all about. Yeah, I want all y'all to have the mindset, man. Have the mindset, you know that you was appointed for these things that are going to happen to you. You understand? Then when that happened, we don't want to see brother been out of shape. Yo, what happened to the brother? Oh, nah, man, I stopped wearing my fringes. Because they're looking for brothers that have fringes on to put to death. Yeah, man. Yeah. At my job, I stopped opening the Bible. They're looking for brother that opened Bible to put to death. You understand? Now, I start coming from Clubhouse, well, because I don't know the enemy might listen to. Private man. Yo, it's going to happen, brothers. I'm going to show you that. Same thing happened, brother. This is the mindset. Let's go to the Maccabees right quick. Yeah, you finished that? Yep. No. Where you at? Where you was reading?
First Thessalonians 3:3.
3:3? Yes, and jump to 5 right quick.
First Thessalonians 3:5. 1 Thessalonians 3:5.
Uh-huh.
For this cause, when I could no longer forbear, I sent to know your faith, lest by some means the tempter have tempted you, and our labor be in vain.
I want your guys to pay attention to what he said. He finished telling us that, yo, the affliction we're gonna take is gonna be death, torment, all type of things gonna happen. Then he said, the tempter. Because the tempter might come. When it's time for your death, the tempter will tempt you. You don't have to take it, brother. All you have to do, go back to Christian church. You don't have to take it. Go back to being Islam, brother. You don't have to take it, brother. Go back being the home of adultery, fornicator. Go back there. The tempter will come and say, this is not the way. That's why they say unless. That's why it's a serious things when you see brothers and sisters, you don't see them in the Sabbath. You don't see them in the feast days. What the hell they're doing? That tempter easy to go and mess with you when you by yourself. What the scripture said is better to do what? It's better two better than one, my brothers. Mm. two better than one, my brothers. Now let's jump. Let's go through 1 Maccabees for time's sake. Remember, brother, we jumping from mortal to immortal. You understand? Come on.
1 Maccabees 1.
Yeah, 1 Maccabees 2. This is the Maccabees.
2 verse
times
1.
Of the Greeks, brother. Yeah, you thinking it's only you went through it. In that generation, they went through things. In this generation, we will go through things. It's a matter of time. But I want your guys, you know what I mean? I'm trying to, I ain't trying to spare you, but I want your guys to understand that. Come on, 2, let's start at 27 right quick.
It's the book of 1 Maccabees, chapter 2 and verse 27. And Mattathias cried throughout the city with a loud voice, saying, whosoever is zealous of the law and maintaineth the covenant, let him follow me.
And listen to what the brother said. Read it again.
And Mattathias cried throughout the city with a loud voice, saying, whosoever is zealous of the law and maintaineth the covenant, let him follow me.
Put a brother that's teaching too, man. I like that too. Brother that's cheating. It's the same thing, you know. When we go in the street, what we teach? Commandments. Whosoever fear God, follow us. I like the picture though with the horse. Because that's what we're doing in these streets, brothers. Yeah, I mean, we bring the laws of God in these streets. Whoever fear God, gonna follow us. Mm-hmm. You understand? Come on.
Verse,
some good stuff.
Verse 28.
Go ahead.
So he and his sons fled into the mountains and left all that ever they had in the city.
That's what I want your guys to build your spirit into. You know things will happen, right? Then you know when things happen to you, guess what? The neighbor that you love, when they notice that the house has not been open for a couple of days, guess who's going to nuke the house? Guess who's going to steal? Guess who's going to wipe the house? That might be your cousin. Oh, damn, he was an Israelite. I think, I heard they arrest a lot of, I wonder if that's him. And then he go to your house, wipe, take the TV, take everything. You're going to lose everything. Have the mindset to leave everything behind. Right. You understand? Meaning that everything already gone. The thing you see inside your house, have a mindset they're already gone. That's the mindset you're going to have. That's what a lot of you are. You're in a la-la land. Come on.
Verse 29. Then many that sought after justice and judgment went down into the wilderness to dwell there.
You see that? The white men don't have no justice. The white men don't have no judgment in them. It's only through the commandments we can deal justly with one another. But the white man, the devil, is unjust. You understand? Come on.
Both they and their children,
uh-huh,
and their wives,
uh-huh,
and their cattle,
uh-huh,
because afflictions increased sore upon them.
Y'all see that thing? Affliction, that's like you fled. You understand? You fled from your house, your comfort zone, your nice crib, your nice night, the 72-inch TV. You understand? Now it's 85, 90-inch of TV. You understand? The best radio system. You understand? That best iPhone. You understand? Your comfortable zone. Your jacuzzi. What's that called? Jacuzzi. I can't even say that thing. You understand? Your marble floor. You understand? You're going to be fled. You're going to lose it all. Come on.
Because afflictions increased sore upon them.
You see that? Affliction. When you decide to keep God's commitment, brothers, apply it, teach your people it, guess what? That's what they come on with. Affliction. But we just read it. We was appointed to it. So what the hell are you bugged out for? Yeah, I mean, what the hell are you bugged out for? Nah, brother, I just want to make sure your guys with me, man. You know, I've been in jail for 3 days. There's no lawyer see me yet already. Brother, just lean back, lean back, lean back. Everything going to be all right. Lean back, lean back. Because the devil will come and say, see, brother, don't care about you. You understand? But it's not, we don't have access to that. Instead of thinking that, damn, maybe this brother don't have access to send a lawyer to doing that. But we bring all these things forward, Cap. You're going to have brother in the last day when they get arrested and still have the dumb thoughts overshadow them. Damn, brother doesn't give a damn about me. He go through the window. Yo, what you want? Can I talk to somebody, please? I know where the prophet's at. I know where my wife is. I know where my kids. He give it all because he wanted freedom. But you was appointed to go to jail. You was appointed to leave your house. You was appointed. You understand? That's nothing new under the sun, brother. Better buckle up. Come on.
Hey, D, you know what's heavy? What you just said jumped in my spirit? Because we always had safe houses. We always had places we could go and hide. Like you said, they get in there and want to tell them, I know where the safe house at. They want to give everybody up in there. You understand?
Yeah, you know that brother that feel comfortable. You know what I mean? It's the brothers that they're looking at the time they're in right now. House is sky high, expensive. They cannot go higher than it is right now. But brother, imagine that's all you got. In the land of America, how does system work? Up and down, up and down, up and down. That's knowledge. When you know up and down, right? Then you let that thing, you ain't take nothing off that crib. Mm-hmm. Then you can say, you know what? I'm building this thing in Africa. It's mine. Yeah, they don't arrest you for credit. You know that, right?
Right.
The hell with that white man needs credit. Yeah. Man, but this is yours. This is yours. You ain't the one. This is yours. No bill, no nothing. But you had a chance to build something.
Yeah, right.
You had your chance to do something. But you was too wise. You was too wise, man. Be smart, brothers. Be smart. Don't caught up in the hype, brother. Do not caught up in the hype. I'm telling y'all, man. Read Job 9:24, man, for these brothers that's sleeping there. Oh no, y'all guys don't. Y'all think we don't know what we're talking about? But when these things happen, there was a brother. I told a brother with that token stuff. I said, "Yo, I said, you believe that white man that much, brother?" He said, "Nah, do you know, man? You know, my brothers is in it. Everybody's in it. They're trying to get this money, man." I'm like, "Yeah." I like, if I was you, man, I'd just take some, leave some, bro. At least you got something. And that thing went down. The brother looked at me in my eyes and said, D, you right. I was right when I told you that. you just didn't find out now I was right. Come on.
It's the book of Job, chapter 9, verse 24.
Mm-hmm.
The earth is given into the hand of the wicked.
Hey, listen, the scripture says the earth is given to wicked men. Why, when you get to finance, you believe the white man so much?
Right.
But you know he's a wicked man. You better examine yourself. Y'all better examine yourself, man. Think wise, brother. Think wise. I'm not saying sell your thing, man, but think wise between the line what you can do. I mean, that's not going to hurt you that much, but it's something you can call your own if something went down. You understand? Because if something going down, you know what you're going to deal with? Your thoughts. Nobody give a damn about me. Where's the brothers? Where the sisters? Where the hiding spot? Where this and that? Where the, but you're supposed to at least have your little hiding spot. You can like, yo, I'm out. I'm salute, brothers. I'll see you guys later. Let me go in this side, preach. But you didn't serve nothing. You didn't do nothing because you didn't use wisdom. All right? Come on. Now we learn about the Maccabees, right?
Yes, sir.
Now let's jump to verse 61 right quick. We're going to skip that. We're gonna jump because our time is off. Come on.
First Maccabees chapter 2, verse 61. And thus consider ye throughout all ages that none that put their trust in him shall be overcome.
You see that? When we put our trust in God, we never overcome by no man. That's what we want your guys to understand. Put your trust in him. Build your character. Build yourself up. Build your self-esteem up. You understand? You the son of the living God. You the daughters of the living God. Build yourself up. You understand? You have to build yourself up. But a lot of us, you know what's going on inside our head? We confuse. When it get to the system, we confuse. Brother, you're going to lose everything. So prepare yourself for that. Come on.
Verse 62. Fear not then the words of a sinful man.
Read it again.
Fear not then the words of a sinful man.
America gonna made to be nothing, brother.
Damn.
You see all that base they have throughout the world? They're gonna make to be nothing. It's just gonna be like a dream. Nothing. The destruction they're coming for this place is gonna make it like nothing.
That's
dust.
Right.
That's it. They're gonna turn to dust. You gonna give your soul for that? You crazy. Come on.
Fear not then the words of a sinful man.
Fear not the word of the sinful man. That's what the white man is. A sinful man. Come on.
For his glory shall be dung and worms.
See, now that's not my word. You thought that was my words. Dung means shh. His glory gonna turn to shh. Come on, brother.
Verse 63. Today he shall be lifted up.
Today, America is the great country in the world. Let's show me, show me, show me how many country that covered, brother. Show me. Show me the basis. Show me the greater America. Because guess what? The Assyrian was great at one time. Babylon was great at one time. Persia, Mede and the Persian was great at one time. I mean, the Greek was great at one time. Rome was great at one time. Now we got the great Babylon. The wicked of all nations in this planet Earth. Let's read about them. Look at it. Look at the greatest power. It's the greatest power. You see, this thing passed the imagination of men. America proved that man is powerful, but not powerful than God.
That's right.
Come on, man. How could you get away with things like that? Yo, how could you get away with things like that if Satan is not with you, man? Let's read the thing before we go. What Satan promised when he told Christ, I will give you all that kingdom. This is what happened to America. This is what happened. And just leave the base there, man. Just leave the base there. You have to show me. You know what I mean? I know I'm good looking, but you have to show me. You see, you have to have the confidence. Even though you're ugly, you have to have confidence.
No. This is the book of Matthew, chapter 4, and verse 8. Again, the devil taketh him up into an exceeding high mountain.
Come on, man.
And showeth him all the kingdoms of the world.
Showed him all the kingdoms of the world. It showed him past, present. It showed everything. Yeah, listen. I will give you all these things there. Come on.
And the glory of them.
The glory of them. That's what we just see. The glory of America was given by Satan. The glory of America was given by Satan, man. Look at that base. Look at that going people countries. Invade people country. Greatest kingdom in the planet in very young age. 200 something years. He's very young. Very powerful. But God will quench that thing.
That's right.
Christ is going to quench it. Come on.
And saith unto him, all these things will I give thee if thou wilt fall down and worship me.
You see that? The white man worship who? Satan. For his glory. That's the glory of the white man. You see how easy it is? So when you say the white man is the devil, it's easy, brother. Because Satan is granting his glory. Look at his glory. His kind of glory. He invade country, rob country, rape country, destroy waste of people, sell soul. Destroy soul, but God Almighty will bring this kingdom down. Let's get it in Daniel, bro. Let's see the end of this thing here. That's why we have to put your trust in God. Cannot put your trust in men. Let's see what Daniel see in the vision, brother, if America stay alive. Daniel 9, I think it is, right? It's all their kingdom.
Daniel chapter 7 verse 9.
Okay, go ahead.
I beheld till the thrones were cast down.
Let's go.
And the Ancient of Days did sit.
Come on.
Whose garment was white as snow. And the hair of his head like the pure wool.
Come on.
His throne was like the fiery flame. And his wheels as burning fire.
Mm-hmm.
And fiery stream issued and came.
Mm-hmm. Hey, did I pass it?
13.
Go ahead. I think I missed something.
Verse 13, I saw in the night visions.
He saw in the night vision. Come on.
And behold, one like the Son of Man.
One into like a son of a man. Come on.
Came with the clouds of heaven.
Uh-huh.
And came to the Ancient of Days.
Uh-huh.
And they brought him near before him.
Uh-huh.
And there was given him dominion and glory and a kingdom that all people, nations, and languages shall serve him.
Stop. Read it again. Y'all don't get it. Read it again, brother.
And there was given him dominion.
No, read it from the top. What you just read. Come
on. I saw in the night vision.
He saw in the night vision, right? Come on.
And behold, one like the Son of Man.
Man. One into a son of man. Come on.
Came with the clouds of heaven.
He come with the cloud of heaven. Come on.
And came to the Ancient of Days.
Who give Christ the power?
The Ancient of Days.
Who give Christ the power?
The Ancient of Days.
Who give the white man his power? Satan. Christ, his power coming from the Father. That's why he told Satan, get behind me, man. Everything belongs to me. What the hell are you talking about? Come on, read it again.
And came to the Ancient of Days.
Come on.
And brought him near before him.
Come on.
And there was given him dominion
and glory and a kingdom that all people, nations, and languages should serve him.
That's the kingdom we're looking for, brother. That's the kingdom we're looking for. But for us to inherit this kingdom, brother, we have to endure, brothers. We have to endure. We have to endure, man. We have to endure. You finished?
There's more. His dominion is an everlasting dominion.
You see that? We no longer going into captivity, brothers. Because that kingdom is an everlasting kingdom. Read it again, brother.
His dominion is an everlasting dominion.
Uh-huh.
Which shall not pass away.
Uh-huh.
And his kingdom, that which shall not be destroyed.
That's right. Because guess what, brothers? We're going to rule with Christ.
That's right.
Our mortal body going to turn to immortal body. Everlasting life. That's what we're working for, brothers. You got to get rid of your envy, hatred, malice, deceit, bitterness, complaint. Backbiter? What's the other thing?
Murmuring.
Gossip, murmuring. Yeah, you got to get rid of all of that, man. You cannot build your body to an immortal when you're fighting these things. That cannot happen, brother. You're going to lose. You're going to lose out of that. You notice we did the last little end again, so our brothers may understand.
And there was given him dominion and glory and a kingdom that all people, nations, and languages should serve him.
Let me tell you something. The nation, they will decide not to serve Christ. What do you think is going to happen to them? Death. 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 That's what's going to happen to them. Come on, man. Read.
His dominion is an everlasting dominion,
uh-huh,
which shall not pass away.
It shall not pass away, brothers. That's what Isaiah said. What is it? When they say the world with no end. Yeah. You understand? Yeah. Let's get that. You understand? Then we end it with that. We want your guys to stay in the spirit, brothers and sisters. No matter how Satan trying to come at you, knock you out, stand up on your feet. Fight. Fight. Fight, brothers. Fight. Come on.
Isaiah chapter 45, verse 17.
Uh-huh.
But Israel shall be saved in the Lord. With an everlasting salvation,
uh-huh,
ye shall not be ashamed nor confounded.
Uh-huh.
World without end.
World with what?
World without end.
That's the world we're waiting for, brothers. Clap your hand for yourself. We're in the building. We're in the building. All praise to the Most High. I think Deacon Abiel is next.